Oh, welcome. Shut the fuck up, everybody. Welcome to Maniacal Music Musings. We are the Wild Boys here. Especially me. I'm your host, Jeremy. You know, I was a smooth operator during my glory days. Voices carry, though, so I can't say that too loud. Otherwise, you know. But nowadays, though, I found all I need in this freeway of love. Though, when I met my wife. But enough about me. Let's talk about the man we're honoring tonight, though. All through the night, he likes to strut in his raspberry beret. Suddenly, he remembers his one night in Bangkok with the boys of summer and his obsession over material girls. For him, though, things can only get better, as he says, all I need to do is go do the neutron dance with a view to kill. The early birthday boy, Chancy motherfucking Grave!
Hi. I want to go on record saying that the only thing from 1985 that was cool was me.
Nice.
I heard nice. Material Girl. I was like, wait a minute. Hey, is that my belt you got there, Harvey?
Yes. I'm holding on to it for you, and I figured since we're going to be on screen together, the least I can do is carry it with the distinction that you would. No, you know, I'm just a placeholder, sir.
Nah. Whoever won, did you win it?
No. Who won it last? Were you the last person to have it?
I don't know. I won it by the greatest landslide in history is what it was.
I think you were the last champion. We haven't had a chance to do Jeopardy to you know, to see who gets the belt. But, you know, like
it
I said.
It was a shutout and a landslide.
You know, for the original title holders to come back and take it eventually. But
all right.
But, yes, and Chancy, can you guess the topic?
I'm guessing it has something to do with the year of my birth, 1985.
Well, it was either going to be that or it was going to be the year you were conceived. But I thought that'd get a little weird thinking about like which song your parents were listening to while you were conceived. So, you know.
Well, I mean, it was 1980. It was my dad. It was probably something from before the year I was conceived, if we're going to be honest. Or there was no music at all. My dad seems like the kind of guy that would do hardcore missionary in the dark with no sound.
What is hardcore missionary?
I don't know. Something super vanilla that white folks do. I got no idea, man.
Oh, okay. Valid. Yeah, I don't know nothing about that.
He's holding their own knees and his hands are on his own hips.
Right?
No, it's what the Hasidic Jews do when all they do is cut a hole in the sheet and put the rest of the sheet over the body.
Valid.
Yeah. Don't ask me how I know these things. But, yes, we are here to do a two-part bracket of songs from 1985. Because that's the year that Chancy was born, and it was the year for a lot of good music, too. So I said, fuck it, let's do this. It's either this or it's a bracket of songs that have to do with putting the tip in the eye socket. So that'd be hard to make. So
that's a short list, I think. I don't know.
It would be hard to make, but but we're doing 1985 songs. But first things first, giggity. But let me introduce our guest that we got for this round tonight. Tomorrow's guest may vary. Chancy doesn't know. So, aha. But our guest tonight are starting from my right. Casey Box from An Evening at the Movies podcast and from I Did Not Make These Rankings Network. And followed by a guy diagonally down from him, another member of the same network, host of Men of the Prize and host of Love is Black, hashtag when done right, Harvey Laguerre. Currently holding his BBC.
With both hands, sir. With both hands.
Safety first.
Damn right.
And our next guest, hailing from the Noize Report and the upcoming Racket Bracket podcast, the music god himself.
Live from the House of Fuckery, bitches.
Nice.
House of Fuckery. Oh, damn.
CJ Wayne.
I like that. The House of Fuckery.
I like that. That's what we have officially dubbed this studio, walk-in closet, whatever the fuck you want to call it.
We call it a pod studio, sir. We call it a pod studio. Which I need I need one built away from these dogs, damn it. But our next guest, all the way from Crime Rewind Podcast, Miss Shana Lindaman herself in her lovely black screen.
I got a picture up. You don't see me?
Not moving. I mean,
no, nope, I see you.
I could leave that up if you want.
You can see me. I can see you. You can't see me.
Oh Lord.
And of course, last but not least, the reason we need to have Ron because she is the better half of our almost birthday boy. And she had to drag two fingers up his ass to get him in here tonight. So
Jesus.
Okay. Miss Kasey.
I mean, I walked in from my office. I don't know where they
I just got home.
I wasn't compelled by any unnatural force. Like, I don't know. I was like, hey, we gotta go in here. Oh, okay, here we go.
Notice how he doesn't think Kasey wearing him as a hand puppet is unnatural.
Yeah. Hi, Kasey. Hi, other Kasey.
Don't know which one I was, so I went down.
No, as the lady, you were Lady Kasey is first, and then the other Kasey is second.
I was going to say, Harvey the gentleman. Of course he said lady.
Damn right. You know how I do.
All right. Well, the order tonight is going to go. The birthday boy starting us out. I know I'm excited too, Moose. I'm excited too. But the birthday boy starts us out, followed by CJ, then Harvey, then myself, then Kasey, then Shana, then Waller. So Waller, right. you get to bring up the rear for Chancy. There you go. And just so everybody knows, I did not.
Yeah, my Jeremy.
I'm not the one doing it, her. But I did not make these rankings. These rankings were made by Billboard. So you got any problem with it? Yeah, I know. Fuck Billboard, but blame Billboard. And the first matchup that Chancy gets to start off for his bracket tonight is number 49, Diana Ross is Missing You, versus number 64, Phil Collins, Don't Lose My Number.
Oh, Diana Ross. I gotta go with Diana Ross. I mean, Phil Collins is all right, but not when you put him up against Diana Ross.
I love how Harvey's already dancing
in the screen. He's got it in his head already. He's like,
yeah.
Yeah. All right. And that's gonna actually bring it down to CJ.
Wrong. Diana Ross.
Diana Ross gets another one. And that's a bring down to Harvey, who is, as I know, a big Phil Collins lover as well. But
I love Diana Ross. I love the Supreme.
Huge lover.
But I mean, you know, I'm a monster fan of Phil Collins. Random bit of information, not that you care. Diana Ross and Marvin Gaye were supposedly close. So that song Missing You was about Marvin because he had died pretty close to that.
Oh, man. I did not know that.
Yeah.
Bonus points if you can name who wrote the song.
Missing You. I'm pretty sure it was her. Diana Ross was not a songwriter. I don't know. That's a damn good thing. I wish I knew. I'm going for Phil Collins, though, because I love Don't Lose My Number.
It is one of five songs on this list that Lionel Richie either wrote or was involved in.
That man was in the room when every song was written in 1985. Let's just be honest. Lionel Richie's a bad motherfucker. Doesn't surprise me that Lionel wrote that. Okay.
And that brings it down to me. And unlike my good friend Freddie, who likes to shit on Phil Collins every chance he gets, I personally love Phil Collins. Even though a lot of his songs seem to be about murder. I don't know why, but...
None of his songs are about murder. Damn.
Yeah, one of his songs is about drowning a hooker in a river, but you know.
You heard one urban rumor and you believed it. This shit is not about drowning anyone. What is... It's...
Hey, I was listening to one of his songs today and it just fucking was like... What the fuck is he singing about?
He was in the midst of a divorce. That's what that song is about. If you listen to it, he ain't trying to kill nobody.
So he wanted off that hoe, okay? But
off that hoe, damn the white, you know.
Well, out of these two songs, I gotta go with Phil Collins. Diana Ross, I'm a fan of, but that song, no, not that song. It's too. I know you hate it too. I know. But
I'm going on record as saying Phil's son is a better drummer than Phil is.
Say what?
Phil's son is a better drummer than Phil.
Ooh, it really interesting. I haven't heard him. Is that legit, or are we just saying that to cause some havoc?
No, he actually, when Phil couldn't play drums anymore on the last tour, his son actually played all the drums on the tour.
Oh, nice. Oh, okay. Well, it helps to learn from your father when your father is Phil Collins. Yeah.
All right, and that means that the next, it's all tied up at this point because of me, so that means Kasey gets to go next. With a K.
Phil Collins. Life.
Shana, are you going to get Phil Collins the win, or are you going to tie it up for Waller?
So here's the thing with me right now. The only song I can hear in my head about not losing numbers is the Milli Vanilli one. And I can't get that out of my head.
Well, you can hear it, but you can't see them singing it, that's for sure.
No, and that's the thing. Like, baby. Don't you lose my number. So, because of that fact alone, I gotta go with Phil Collins.
Which means Phil Collins wins this matchup. But, Walter, which way would you have gone for dexterity purposes?
For dexterity.
There's no wrong answer here, by the way.
I'm aware. It is my opinion, my choice.
She's had a playlist, sir.
Yeah, Jeremy, we all know what that means. Anyway, it doesn't mean shit. Anyway.
Because you don't listen.
Didn't she have a playlist last week? When was I supposed to listen to this to where he wouldn't find out?
I was going to say, if I heard her listening to a playlist of all songs from 1985, I'd have been like, okay, hold on. What are you doing? You're not that fucking interested in 1985. I don't understand what's going on here.
I'll go with Diana.
just like the princess, she didn't make it through this one. But
I will be honest, I lost the fact that these weren't Chancy's picks, and I was real confused for a while.
Understandable.
Well, that means that CJ gets to start off this next matchup, which I guess are easy, but we'll see what everybody else says. And it's
better give me a good one.
It's number 48, Survivors, The Search Is Over, versus number 63, Mary Jane Girls In My House.
Yeah, this one's not even close, dude. Jim Patrick's one of the greatest songwriters of all time. Survivor all day.
And Harvey, what about you?
Oh, it's me. Mary Jane Girls. I'm thinking that might be Rick James. I think he might have wrote that. I think that was his girl group. I'm not sure. I'm gonna go with the Mary Jane Girls.
I'm Rick James, bitch. But and hey, if you go with the Mary Jane Girls, you're just like me and Chancy our whole life then, basically. So, but that's gonna bring it down to me and. Personally, these two songs, Survivor definitely does a better song. So, and that's a good, like, wedding song, kind of. Look at me getting all romantic and shit. But, Kasey, which way are you going to go?
I will definitely say that The Search Is Over. My vote was with me all the while. Survivor.
And, Shana, are you going to put Survivor through, or are the Mary Jane Girls getting another vote?
Mary Jane Girls.
Ooh. And Waller?
You would.
Huh?
She got caught unaware.
Okay, listen, I was sharing the stuff to my Facebook wall, so I didn't hear the options.
Oh, yeah, I forgot Mary about Jane, that. It's Mary Jane Girls in My House versus Survivor, The Search is Over.
Oh, Mary Jane.
Which means Chancy gets a tiebreaker.
Oh. You know, this is actually tricky for me. Because, I mean, you know, CJ's got a point. Survivor's pretty solid. I fucking love Rick James, though. He's like my spirit animal.
He's my inner voice.
Yes, that too. I'm gonna go with Mary Jane Girls. I'm gonna do it. I'm pulling trigger.
Yes, keep it black, baby. You put a one-hit wonder over one of the greatest songwriters of all time.
I did.
It's what we do.
Let's just say that's not one of his best songs.
Disappointing people since circa 1985.
Wow.
Well,
you're fired, Harvey. Chancy.
Well, it's don't worry, it's playing Phil Collins next round, so I have a feeling it's not going too far. But the next one gets started by Harvey, and I'm happy Harvey's starting this one out because it's number 47. No, in 85, you kidding me? But it's number 47's Whitney Houston's You Give Good Love versus number 62. Sade, Smooth Operator.
Oh, it's Sade.
He does it every time.
Piss me off. Smooth Operator.
It's Sade, and it's the two worst songs on the playlist versus each other.
Excuse me? What did I just
Smooth get? Operator is a horrible song that was overplayed.
And You Give Good Love is a bad song, dude?
Yes. It was one of Whitney's worst songs. It's a boring song. It's another Lionel Richie song that's boring. Wow. Whitney had so many better songs in this one.
Wow. You sound like a Will Smith fan. I don't know what I'm going to go with. Let's see. Wow.
Really not
wow. Oh, I'm going with Sade.
Going with Sade? Okay.
I'm going with Sade. Sade Adu. That's her name.
Yes. I mean that sounds like you're drunk at a ghetto party being like, Sade, get on your knees.
It's actually pronounced Sade though.
That's Sade. I'm Nigerian. I think that's how they say it. Sade Adu. Yes.
Well, okay, it's ew. Really, dude? It's my vote next. And I am not a big fan of You Give Good Love. It's not. I didn't like the song that much. The flow was just not right for me.
You didn't even listen to that song, dude. Stop it.
I listened to both these playlists multiple times this week. Thank you.
That's the first time you listened to that Whitney song. It's okay, though. It's all right.
Well, Harvey, I don't need to listen to this. I don't need to listen to a song to give good love. I get good love my own.
You give good love your own. Oh my god.
I'm going with Smooth Operator because I like that song.
Damn right you do.
And which way you want to go, Kasey?
So I have a personal request that I think somebody in this posting for this live broadcast needs to tag Miss Kendra Beltran with the fact that Harvey and Kasey both voted for Sade to make it out of the first round. For life.
Sade. Shit. Talking about Smooth Operator? Classic track.
Well, Shana, is it Whitney Houston or are you going to give Sade the win?
If I could slap you through this screen, I would.
I think you're just doing it to fuck up Harvey at this point.
Order him a glitter bomb.
Go ahead, slap me.
Looks like eating a cracker.
I feel like Smooth Operator is what I play in my head when I'm creeping at the bar. Slithering around like a super creep. So I'm going to have to go with Smooth Operator.
Nice. Nice.
Yeah.
He's a super creep. Super creep.
Super creepy.
And Walter, which way you want to go?
I want to choose Smooth Offer.
And Chanty?
Yep.
And CJ, do we have our first sweep of the bracket here?
Let me go on record here. Both of these songs are horrible examples for the artist. Sade is an absolutely stunning and amazing performer. The Smooth Operator is not a good example of her. There are so many better songs that she does. So I am going for Sade because I do love her. I just don't like that song itself. And she is Nigerian and Moroccan.
All right.
Yes, flawless. Yes, chick is beautiful.
Yes, gorgeous. She is. To this very day, she's got a new record coming out this year, finally. So,
Thank God.
So I can come up with a new tag song for my hype song when I'm trolling the bar. Just better come up with something Shana friendly.
I promise, Harvey, I'm not completely hopeless.
you close.
Shana, I gotta say, I think your Creeping the Bar song should be Rape Besides by Dog Fashion Disco.
What song?
Rapist Eyes by Dog Fashion Disco.
Oh, yeah.
It's a good song, but I mean, you know, context and stuff.
I'm probably not going to get anybody to my car with it, though.
I wouldn't count on that. you might be concerned about the type you get in your car on that one. But
I'd say you're talking about men.
Also valid. Also valid.
Would you like to suck my poopy?
And you live in Iowa, so God knows. But that means that I'm prime real estate
in Iowa.
So you're talking about a species that lives in the Steel Panther, so.
And that means that I get to start off the next matchup to see what Smooth Operator is going to face. And it's number 46, Sheena Easton Strut, versus number 61, Harold Faltermeyer's Axel F. As much as I love Axel F, and I love playing Axel F on DJ Hero back in the day, I gotta go with Strut because I like that song a lot, and her and that album cover, I would watch her strut all fucking day of my life. So, 100%, I'm going with Strut. Sheena Easton can get it, but Casey, which way you want to go, Casey? You're muted on your headset, not on the computer.
Okay, better?
There you go.
So, I smiled a little bit when I looked down in the bottom corner, and you said Axel F. Harvey just sitting down there with a big Eddie Murphy smile on his face, popping his head back and forth to Axel F. playing in his head. So, I'm going to go with theme song to one of the greatest comedic franchises of all time. Excellent.
Well, just so you know, it's not the only theme song from that movie in this bracket. So
1985. Is Patti LaBelle in here too?
I don't believe so, actually.
New Attitude is not in this? Okay, it's fine. I'm so excited.
I thought she was.
Oh, whatever. We'll get to it.
Wrong.
Okay. Yeah, we'll get to it.
I thought it was Neutron Dance at Patti LaBelle.
Neutron Dance is not Patti LaBelle. That's the sisters.
My bad.
But that means it's Shanna's choice next. Is it Strut or Axel F?
Axel F.
And Waller?
Yep.
I know you like the Strut. Which way are you going to go?
She already voted.
It cut out. Yep. I can hear her.
Axel.
She said yep. That's why. Sometimes the yups are so short, like they cut out. Like it's weird.
I think you were just imagining the Strut.
Well, I mean, Her Instagram pictures paint a vivid picture, but. But Chancy, which way you want to go? Are you gonna push Axel F through, or Strut getting another vote?
Oh, I'm totally pushing Axel through. When I was a kid, I always used to get that and fucking Herbie Hancock's Rocket mixed up. Just fucking, I love that. I love Rocket. And every time I'd hear that fucking Axel F song, I'd get super stoked, and then I'd be like halfway through, I'd be like, wait, this isn't the right one. And then I'd be kind of mad about it. I'd be like, oh, it's fucking good, though. Fuck it. Yeah, well, we're here.
And CJ, which way you want to go?
Sorry, guys, but I'm going with the greatest Prince song that Prince never wrote.
I was going to say the song
that actually led to Sheena Easton working with Prince for the Batman soundtrack and later on. So, got to go Sheena Easton.
And it doesn't matter at this point, unfortunately.
Not that it matters, but.
And Harvey, which way would you have gone?
Yo, Sheena Easton is gorgeous, but she was all pristine and untouched. Of course, Prince gets his hands on her, and all of a sudden she's putting out some. Woo, Prince, she was bad. Bang. I love Beverly Hills Cop, but Strut is the beginning of like some of the sexiest music that she put out. She was gorgeous. Strut's a damn good track. Doesn't matter, but I would have gone with Strut.
Which means Axel F does move on, unfortunately, 4-3. But
Sheena Easton, my God.
How a fucking Melody with a beat fucking moves on past an actual like song. I don't know. But
Sheena and Tina McGree both were corrupted by Prince.
Oh, Apollonia. Glamorous Life. Sheila E.
Yes.
My God. Fucking hero, man.
I want to corrupt Apollonia. Fuck.
Hey, I just interviewed Prince and Sheila E's godson, and he's amazing.
That's what you were saying. I saw that.
Michael Gabriel, he's amazing. His dad is actually the president of Paisley Park, and his mom is the manager for Sheila, and he plays guitar in Sheila's band. He's incredible. Check him out.
But that means that Kasey gets to start this next matchup. And just because I want to watch,
which Kasey?
That's Kasey next to me. And
I'm Kasey. That's Waller.
Yeah, that's Waller.
Oh, smart! I like it. I like it a lot.
Well, it's her nickname because Chancy likes to put her up against the wall. You know.
Well, no, she actually has an official title.
No, I don't.
See, shut up. She really does. And she really does, though.
Y'all, oh my God.
Keep it professional, Prez. Keep it professional.
All right, I'll take the advice of my vice president, and we'll keep it going.
Don't Bill Clinton this shit. But Kasey starts off this one. It's number 45, Phil Collins Sussudio, versus number 60, Tears for Fears, Head Over Heels.
Something happens when I'm head over
heels. 85 was a damn good year. What?
Trust me, I've seen the damn playlist, Harvey. This is not the hardest match. I'm just
full of hard, from the big chair. What? That album is Kip. Wow. Okay. Okay, okay. I see you. Damn, I wish I'd looked at this playlist.
Actually, it's probably making more fun with you being surprised.
The playlist is loaded, but it's just how the matchups fall is what's going to make the difference.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because I don't put them in the order on the playlist that they're going to be matching together. Not purpose. At all. Mm-hmm. But, Kasey, which way you want to go?
Studio. Studio,
which whatever that means, actually. And Shana.
Whenever I hear Studio, I always think of that scene in American Psycho when Patrick Bateman is like dancing around. So I gotta go with that.
Oh Jesus God!
And Waller.
Yeah.
And Chancy, is Phil Collins moved on, or is Tears for Fears getting a vote?
You know, when Shana brought up American Psycho.
Oh, God.
And I heard people going, when Kasey was like, studio, I was like, you know, that, and then, like, they all kind of lined up. I'm going to go with it. Only because of the American Psycho reference.
Well, don't worry, folks. It won't be the only Tears for Fear song in this in this whole bracket of.
They better not.
Of it 68 won't be. Songs.
Clearly, there's a bigger hit of theirs in this year. So.
Oh, there is. But yeah. Which way you want to go, CJ? Which way would you have gone, CJ?
One word.
I will vote against it based on the American Psycho because I can't stand that fucking movie. I detest it with my ass.
God.
So,
CJ.
I love
Tears for Fears. You have a lot of hate and anger in your heart.
Just based on it being Tears for Fears. But the American Psycho reference, that just makes it even sweeter.
So why? Wait, I'm curious. Why do you hate American Psycho so much?
I don't know what it is about that. I don't know if it's Christian Bale's performance or what. But I just, that is one of the very few Christian Bale movies that I just fucking detest.
Yeah,
I've been in love with Christian Bale since Newsies.
That right?
I can hang with Christian Bale, but that movie in and of itself, there's something about that movie that makes me want to stab myself in the face.
Really?
Just, the face.
Wow, that's crazy. I figured you would get the joke. It's a joke.
I mean, I get the joke. It's just not funny. Like, it ranks up there with, like I posted today. They got all this new shit with Sebastian Maniscalco coming up. And that dude is like the modern Dane Cook. They're about as funny as watching a funeral. You know?
Ooh, like, we don't agree on anything. Jesus, CJ.
Dude, Sebastian Maniscalco is like the Wish version of Andrew Dice Clay.
Well,
he's like the watered down, boring version of Andrew Dice Clay. Well,
CJ, I'm going to save you with Harvey. He's a huge Prince fan, Harvey.
Yes. Dude, like,
I'm sorry. Who isn't a big Prince fan? Like, you didn't say anything special. Everybody loves Prince.
Okay. I wasn't until we did the bracket.
That's because you hadn't heard the music yet. Once you heard the music, you're like, oh, shit, that's Prince. It's fine.
Now I get it.
Yeah.
Well, Harvey, is it Phil Collins or Tears for Fears?
This is a difficult one for me, but Studio is probably my favorite Phil Collins song ever. In which case, I have to go for it. Has nothing to do with any movie or anything that it's in. I just love how it comes in. It's one of my favorite songs. So Phil gets my vote. I mean, Phil usually gets my vote, but this song especially. And
I vote last. I'm gonna give it to Tears for Fears just so it loses 5-2 at least because they're both amazing songs.
And oh.
I never knew that was Tears for Fears until today. Like I knew one that song, but I never knew it was them.
One of the best albums of the 80s, Songs from the Big Chair, is a phenomenal album.
And actually, Tears for Fears had two bigger hits on that record than
this. Yep. You're right.
But that means that Shannon gets to start off the next matchup to see what Phil's going to face in this round two.
Give her a hard one.
It's going to be number 44. Actually, it might be a hard one for her. I don't know. But it's number 44. Corey Hart's Never Surrender. Versus number 59's Tina Turner, Better Be Good to Me.
Better Be Good to Me. I'm not even it's Tina.
And, apparently Ike didn't take that advice. But which way Ike do you want to go? Ike can go fuck himself.
Yeah. What's baleen wire? Yeah.
Which way you want to go, Waller?
Tina Turner against Phil?
No, against Corey Hart's Never Surrender.
I'll go with Tina Turner.
And how about it's back up to you, Chancy?
Oh, I'm definitely going with Tina Turner.
And that's gonna bring it down to CJ. Tina winning or you're gonna win to Corey?
Yeah, not my favorite Tina song, but fuck it, it's Tina. You always gotta go with that. Yeah, you gotta go with Tina. So,
and Harvey.
Not my favorite Tina song, so I would have voted for Corey.
Well, I would have voted for Corey too, but because I actually don't like that Tina Turner song at all. I like a lot of Tina Turner's hits, but not that song. But which way would you have gone, Kasey?
So just my own personal opinion, this woman was such an iconic and talented singer. And on top of it, when she passed away a couple weeks ago, she's still one of the hottest women ever in the history of music, even at 80-something years old. So, but yeah, I, again, not my favorite Tina Turner song. I would
Tina Turner is beyond Thunderdome.
Definitely way beyond Thunderdome.
And not music,
she
but
definitely is the reason why I don't need another hero.
I don't need another way home.
That's coming up soon, but and I will say that nothing to do with music, musicians, but age and beauty. Martha Stewart looking good in her nude poses at this age.
I beg your pardon?
Martha Stewart, I really don't want to see a nude pose.
Oh,
I don't know. Madonna can still get it.
It's funny you say that, Chancy, because Waller gets to start off this next one, and it's number
flipping the hard shit.
it's funny you said that though, because the next one is number 43, Aretha Franklin's "Freeway of Love," versus number 58, Madonna's "Material Girl," and Waller gets the first vote.
Are you fucking kidding me?
You said Aretha, right, Waller?
Yes.
And Chancy?
Seriously. It's tricky. My mom loves Madonna. But, I mean, you can't deny fucking Aretha Franklin. God damn it, she's fucking it. I'm going to go with Aretha because, you know, fucking solid. But Madonna, though, back in the day.
And CJ, which way you want to go?
You got to go with Aretha. She won a Grammy for the song. I mean, plus it's Aretha.
And Harvey, is it going to be Aretha or Madonna?
This is not the Madonna I love. The Who's That Girl Madonna. That was the one I loved the most. That was... But this is Aretha, like, on the comeback. She had a long run of just nothing. Then she started. Then she made her comeback. This is a great fucking song. So, yes. Freeway of Love. Aretha gets mine.
Yeah, Aretha would have got mine, too, because I actually never heard that song until this week, and I actually really enjoyed that song. But which way you want to go, Kasey?
So, it doesn't matter, but I'm going to reference the fact that Madonna is a material girl in a material world. You ain't got no money, you ain't gonna get no pussy. Reference to Eddie Murphy, stand up from Eddie Murphy Raw. Now that I said that, though, I can't go against Aretha. Aretha is one of the most iconic singers of all time, if not the greatest singer of all time. So, Freeway of Love.
And I just want to say it did break my heart to vote against Material Girl because of its use in Moulin Rouge, but which way do you want to go, Shana?
I cannot let Madonna go without at least one vote, so I gotta go with Madonna. I love that song.
One vote she gets, definitely, and she's Aretha moves on though 6-1, and that means it's back up to Chancy. And he gets to start our play-in match of the night, which I know this one's going to drive Kasey crazy, but Chancy gets to start it. And it's number 65, Cyndi Lauper's All Through the Night, versus number 67, Bruce Springsteen's Glory Days.
Glory Days is a play-in?
Yeah, right? I'm going to go with Glory Days, man.
Is a play-in?
It's they're Glory Days was the second to last rated as it was 67 out of 68. So
I can't wait to hear what 68 is. I can't wait to hear what that is.
All right, well,
no shit.
What'd you say, Chancy? What was your answer, though?
Oh, I'll go with Glory Days. Otherwise, I know fucking Kasey will hop a flight.
Bet your ass, and you better have tacos ready for me when I get there.
Probably the only way I'd survive.
Fuck, if there's tacos, I'm hopping on a flight too. Shit. But
now I'm hungry now.
I ain't talking about Vio's Taco. But which way you want to go, CJ?
I'm going with Cyndi Lauper, another one who is absolutely gorgeous at her age, a voice that is far beyond anything she ever do. Her pop stuff is good, but Cyndi is a generational singer. Like, if you've ever heard her, she does country, she does jazz, she does blues.
Transcendent. Agreed.
Yeah, just a phenomenal, phenomenal person as well.
Whoa.
And one of those songs, DJ too, one of those artists, too, that, like, you may never have heard the song before, but you hear her voice and you're like, that's Cyndi.
Yeah.
Well, Harvey, which way do you want to go?
DJ and Harvey agree on something?
It was bound to happen, dude.
Wow.
Even a blind squirrel finds a nut.
Come on, I'm not a complete heathen. Like, I'm not even partial heathen.
Speaking of agreement here, let's see which way Harvey goes. I'm pretty sure Harvey loves the boss, too.
Well, I mean, I'm from Long Island, so I'm more Billy Joel than I am Bruce Springsteen.
Ooh.
But
it's the same neighborhood.
This is different. You know, something like that.
You do not call New York and New Jersey the same fucking neighborhood. You'll get shot.
You're damn right. Yeah.
Who do you think would win in a bar fight, Billy Joel or Bruce Springsteen?
Billy Joel is in New York.
Billy Joel is a New Yorker that you know how to fight. You kick him in the grizzoins, and then tell him.
And he started out in a metal band named Adilla.
Glory. I think I have to go with Glory Days because it's a song about my favorite sport. I'm a baseball man to my heart. It's my favorite sport, number one. I got to go with Glory Days.
Well, I'm going to tie it up and give one to Cyndi Lauper because I can't tell you, every time I see her singing in that dress, I just want to get down there and lift that dress up and have some fun. So,
hey, if you had Goonies or All Right in here, it would have been a different story. But for now, you know.
They didn't make the list, sorry. But
I don't think it was that year, but it's fine.
She still looks at hot, bro.
But that's not bringing down to Kasey next. Though I'm pretty sure I know which way that's going.
Hashtag fuck you, Jeremy.
F-U-J. Fudge. Fudge. There you go. Wait, fudge.
You're not the winning tiebreaker, but yeah.
I know, but still, at the same time, if it's in almost any other matchup, I could see myself going with Cyndi Lauper. But at the same time, as you and Chancy both know, because of the episode of Maniacal Musifications that I was on before, how much I love fucking F-Q. Glory Days. Glory Days.
And that means it's Shanna's vote. Shana, are you gonna tie it up and we'll go for Cyndi, or are you gonna make Bruce win?
I'm going Cyndi.
Which means that Waller gets the tie-breaking win vote to see who's gonna win this and get put in the first round.
I'll go with Cyndi.
Yeah.
Cyndi makes the comeback. Look at Cyndi.
Okay. She's been doing it her whole life.
Yeah.
But that means that this matchup gets started by CJ, and it's Cyndi Lauper's All Through the Night, which is now in the first round, versus number 42, Jack Wagner's All I Need.
Oh, God.
Cyndi Lauper versus the General Hospital?
Oh, God.
Jack was good, but he ain't Cyndi. Come on now.
Go ahead, Kasey. What?
Wait a minute.
Yes.
That song, Jack Wagner, is a higher ranking than... Oh, hell no.
Yeah.
Hell no.
Cyndi Lauper's a play-in, but
Jack Wagner's in the fucking play-in. Cyndi Lauper's a play-in. Fucking Bruce Springsteen is a play-in, but Glory Jack Days Wagner is automatically
67. It's ridiculous.
Wow.
And you know the thing is, he's probably still talking about ass. You. Jack Wagner's probably like, look at me.
Well,
which is why Billboard is bullshit.
I'm pretty sure it's based on amount of sales too for this era, but
Billboard? No, that's radio play, isn't it? I don't think that's sales.
Well, I was gonna say amount of sales. Fucking Born in the USA as a record sold millions and millions of units.
I'll guarantee you, Born in the USA sold more records than just about everything we've voted on previously.
In this list?
Yeah. I don't know about that.
I know it outsold Tears for Fears. I know it outsold Madonna.
Madonna?
Born in the USA outsold. And it's like number 11 all time on the selling list. It is one of the biggest records of all time, bro.
Wow, that really is like Death eating a cracker when he stands up.
Uh-huh.
But
You Give Good Love. Is that off the Whitney album though? Because that album sold huge. I don't know if it's back. I don't know if it's Born in the USA big, but I think that's in the running to a degree.
But which way you want to go, Harvey?
Is it my turn?
Yeah, it is because CJ went with Cindy. So what are you gonna go with?
So wait a minute. So Cindy versus Jack Wagner.
Yes.
Yeah, Jack Wagner trying to do that blue-eyed soul kind of thing. No, we're going with Cindy on this one.
Yeah, I'm gonna agree with you. Because All I Need is not a bad song at all, but it's not Cyndi Lauper by any means.
He needs to go back to Melrose Place.
Ooh. But which way do you want to go, Kasey? You gonna go for Cyndi or are you gonna go for Jack?
I'm gonna disrespect the shit out of my grandmother, who was a huge ass General Hospital fan, and that's the entity that introduced the world to Jack Wagner. So Cyndi Lauper all day long. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.
Which means Cyndi Lauper moves into the second round. But which way would you have gone, Shana?
Oh, I would have gone Cindy.
And Waller?
Yeah, Cindy.
And Chanty?
Yeah, I'm going with Cindy on this one.
Which means Cindy wins, and we are now at the end of the first half of round one. And this is the other side of round one we're starting. And yeah. Harvey starts us off, and I am so happy he's fucking starting this one off.
Okay.
It's number 51, Prince and the Revolution's Raspberry Beret versus number 41, Howard Jones, Things Can Only Get Better.
Fuck me!
Are you kidding me?
Stop my dick.
I'm sorry. Howard Jones put some That's Prince in the motherfucking Revolution. No disrespect to Howard Jones.
I get it, but
this is not Howard's best song, and you need your best shit to pull up against Prince. That is just not it. No, that's Raspberry Beret, dude.
I get it, Howie. I get it. Harvey, I get it.
Howie.
And it's the kind you find in the secondhand store. It's not even a department store.
Harvey, not Howie. My bad.
It's clearly Prince. Just saying.
Well, personally, this is not one of my favorite Prince songs, so I'm going to give it to Howard Jones because I never knew who sang that song, but every time I hear it in a store, I fucking love it.
What is your favorite Prince song?
It's a tie between Darling Nikki and Let's Go Crazy.
I can see Darling Nikki being one of your favorites.
Right. I mean,
well, you could thank Amanda for that. If she didn't put it in the bracket, I never would have heard of it. Because that's Amanda apparently has had a magazine in a hotel lobby, if you know what I mean. But
you love cream.
Blame the blonde-headed white chick who's not even here.
Don't worry, we got her back if need be. It's all crazy.
But which way you want to go, Kasey? Prince or Howard Jones?
I'm not voting against fucking Prince. I mean, it's Raspberry Beret.
It's fucking Prince.
I mean, it's iconic. I mean,
we all understand.
Yeah, I can't justify going any direction other than Prince. I mean,
it's Prince.
Shana, your vote.
Completely understandable, dude. It's Prince.
But just so everybody knows, that's the only Prince song in this whole bracket. So
that's the only song in '85 that he dropped.
Off that album. That album came out in '85, and that album's not his best album, I don't think. So it's the one that looks like a weird painting, like on the cover.
It's really like the only song in '85 that charted for Prince. When that record come out, the majority of the songs were in '86. So
that's true. '86 is a ridiculous year for the '80s. That would have been a crazy bracket to do.
Yeah.
Well,
'86 and '87 both.
We actually are going to start doing more yearly brackets on months I can't think of special brackets for. So, because I volunteer right now.
Hey, CJ, could you do a bracket? I was born in 74.
I got 3 million songs across 100 genres in my collection. Nice. Name it, and I could talk about it.
Nice. I'm telling you,
there is a reason I have my name. It was not given to me as a joke, okay? This knowledge is deep.
See you guys in February for 1977.
All right, well, that's going to bring it down to Shana. Is it Prince or Howard Jones?
It is going to be Prince, 100%. Prince is my number 4 all-time favorite artist.
Nice.
Waller?
I would fire you for Reapers right now.
Prince.
And Chancy?
It shouldn't even have to be. I mean, it's fucking Prince, man.
Thank you.
It's Raspberry Beret though. It lost pretty fast when we were on CJ's show doing a Prince bracket.
But that was all Prince though. I mean, nobody can beat Prince but Prince.
That's because I came with the deep cuts and put the good shit in there instead of just the junk.
Like, that would be a terrible joke.
CJ, you have to do our Prince bracket on the show one-on-one. Okay.
I'm down.
But
as long as it has Steve in the temple in there, we're okay. Doesn't win, it's got to be in the bracket.
It's not. It's a ranked bracket. It's not in there. But CJ, which way you want to go, Prince or Howard Jones?
Look, I am a massive, massive Howard Jones fan, but I am completely 1,000,000% with Harvey on this. It's like comparing a Chevy Chevette to a Bugatti. You know, you got to go with Prince, man. Like,
this is just Howard just got the wrong end of the stick.
It's just a bad matchup for Howard. Is all like Damn, Howard is fucking is. Phenomenal.
He really
doesn't
is.
Get enough credit, but
really underappreciated. Ferrari You're compared so right. to
a yeah, like it's Prince. Like,
well, let me ask you this, CJ. Have you heard the Within Temptation song with Howard Jones on it?
Except that's Howard Jones from the metal band, not
Killswitch Engage.
All different Howard Jones, bro.
Yeah, wrong Howard Jones, dude.
Your questions, bro. Don't do that. Don't talk to CJ like that.
I was gonna say that's the Harvey version of Howard Jones. Okay, we talking about white English Howard Jones here, like. You in the wrong country, wrong era, wrong genre. Like you ain't even close, bro. Like, come on.
Well, this next matchup gets started by me, and I kind of wish Harvey was starting this one too, but oh well. And it's number 52, Billy Ocean's Suddenly, versus number 40, the Commodore's Night Shift.
Oh, this hurts in a personal way. Ooh.
But and Harvey's going last on this one too. But if we can make him the tiebreaker, that'd be great. But I'm going for Billy Ocean Suddenly because I like that a lot better than I like Night Shift. So because suddenly you're in love. That's just the way life works. So but which way you want to go, Kasey?
What were my choices again?
Billy Ocean Suddenly versus Commodore's Night Shift.
I'm going to go with Billy Ocean just for the pure fact that, you know, Suddenly is a nice mellow jam.
And which way do you want to go, Shana?
Billy Ocean is like one of the kings of smooth from the 80s. So I'm going to have to go with Billy Ocean.
And
until you get out of his dreams and get into his fucking car.
When the going gets tough, the tough get going.
And Waller, which way you want to go?
My car.
I'll go with Billy.
Chancy, you might be wanting to ask him who this Billy fella is, but your vote.
I'm going to throw one to the Commodores, man. Fucking the Commodores go. They fucking take me all the way back.
All right. And that's going to bring it down to CJ. Is it Commodores or Billy Ocean?
Yeah, this is kind of like the last round. I mean, this is just a bad matchup for the Commodores because it's Billy Ocean, bro. And,
yeah, I know. You know, I know.
That's the bro, like, you know. That was baby making music, bro.
I know, right?
Yeah. I'm imagine busting as Riza says, suddenly you're in love. Like, perfect. Like, I don't know. That's just my thing. But CJ, which way you want to go?
I already told you, Billy Ocean, bro.
Oh, yeah. I already got that down. Harvey.
Come on, pay attention. Pay attention.
I was thinking about busting.
Yeah, this is a difficult one. It sounds like it doesn't matter, but
it doesn't. But yeah,
right. We remember Missing You from Diana Ross. That song was for Marvin. So was Night Shift. Yes. Night Shift is an amazing, amazing song. I love Billy Ocean, by the way. But Night Shift is really towards the end of the Commodores. This is like the end of their run, but this is like their, I think their one last really big hit, and I'm gonna go with Night Shift.
Marvin, which means round two is gonna be Prince versus Billy Ocean.
And he could sing a song.
But that means Kasey gets to get the next matchup started, and it's number 53, Don Henley's The Boys of Summer versus number 39. Pat Benatar's We Belong.
Yeah. I want to donkey kick you in your taint.
and I'll be right behind you.
Dude, 85 is awesome.
And this isn't even the top. Right? This isn't even the top 34. Wait for tomorrow night.
This is awesome. Damn.
Jesus, fix it.
This is Pat Benatar. This is Legend of Billie Jean, Pat Benatar. This is
That's a movie I want to watch again real soon.
Oh, fair is fair.
Oh. Thank you, CL. Woo. I love you too, CL.
That actually would be. That would be a good episode to have on an evening into movies. I might actually be Legend of Billie Jean on that episode.
What are you talking about? Hi, if you're doing Legend of Billie Jean, that's, in my opinion, the best movie of the 80s. I will talk about that movie.
That movie made me want a rat tail.
Oh, as a love that fucking movie. I love that movie with a
She's clearly the better Slater sibling.
Yes.
I'm dragging my feet, obviously, because I don't know who to pick in this matchup, because fucking it's Don Henley, Boys of Summer, and it's Pat Benatar. Oh, my God.
I don't know. I think We Belong. I think Napoleon Dynamite, but.
Oh, get that shit out of here. Movie sucks ass. Stop it. Do not besmirch the name of Pat Benatar. Don't do it. That crap ass film. Got a white boy can dance for 3 minutes. That's the whole movie.
If we're going to attach We Belong to any movie, it will be to Talladega Nights, The Legend of Ricky Bobby.
And right.
That's better. Fuck. That's better.
No, that's more like it.
Dude. Are you kidding me?
You going with Pat Benatar?
Napoleon Dynamite?
You're going with Pat Benatar?
Green light anything. Right.
Yeah. Move on to Shana before I change my mind.
Shana, is it The Boys of Summer, which we all know you love them, or We Belong?
I'm more of a winter boy kind of girl, so I'm going to go with Pat Benatar.
Winter is coming.
I'm a winter boy.
I'm a winter for sure. Like,
well,
I don't like to just sit there and sweat for no reason. Like, one time I was sweating, and my daughter had the audacity to ask me, she's like, are you sweating because you just ate? I know.
Oh,
and it was at that point I was like, yeah, I raised her right.
Oh, shit. That was, dude, somebody get her some cream for that burn.
I was like, actually, yes.
Damn.
And Waller, which way you want to go?
Pat Benatar and Don Henley.
Boys of Summer, We Belong.
Going
in the sun.
What'd you say? I didn't hear you over Shana.
She went with Pat Benatar.
And Chancy, which way are you going to go? Don Henley or Pat Benatar?
I'm totally going with fucking Pat Benatar, man.
Chancy's going to a Texas Oklahoma chili cookoff.
I wish.
We're not afraid to use prime meat.
But
this town loves prime meat.
Pat Benatar moves on, but CJ, which way would you have gone?
I have a steadfast rule. There are three women that I never ever vote against. You never vote against Patty. You never vote against Joan Jett. And you never vote against Pat Benatar.
Is that Patty Smythe? Was that the first one? Or is it
Patty LaBelle?
Okay.
The queen. The queen, the most perfect woman to ever grace the earth. My example of the perfect woman.
Okay. Sold.
Hey, Patty's a goddess, bro. Like,
Damn right.
Like, I will fight you over Patty and Shaka Khan, period. Like,
dude.
Well,
I just have tickets.
But which way did you say you wanted to go? Did you want to go? Did you want to go with Benatar or?
Yeah. You always vote for Pat Benatar. Always.
Well, Harvey, how about you? Henley or Benatar?
I am quite a large Eagles fan. This is still an easy vote. It's Miss Benatar. Damn it, it's Pat Benatar with E.
It's,
all right. Well, I'm gonna give one to Don Henley because that song is way better than We Belong to Me, but.
Oh, dude, cut his mic. Cut his mic.
It's my show. It's my show. Ain't no one cutting shit.
Oh, shit. Cut that mic.
Chance he's taking over hosting duties.
All of a sudden, I just do this kind of thing, and I swipe up, and it's just one long fucking shot. I don't know. I don't know any of the rest of these fucking things, but we're just going to kind of wing it.
That's going to be where I start holding up this card.
Yeah.
Exactly.
That means that Shana gets started the next matchup to see what Miss Bantar is going to face. And it's number 54, Murray Heads, One Night in Bangkok, versus number 38, the Pointer Sisters, Neutron Dance.
Oh? Can we make this quick, please? Come on. Come on. If this ain't a sweep,
I gotta go
wrong.
With One Night in Bangkok.
What?
And Waller?
Just because when I was a kid, I always felt like saying Bangkok was something dirty.
And then the other one's called One Night in Bangkok.
Oh, I'll go with the first one.
She's going to go with the Neutron Dance.
The Neutron Dance.
And Chancy?
I also am going with the Neutron Dance.
And
Muser have taste.
I'm sorry. CJ.
Oh, dude. One Night in Bangkok all day. It's one of those songs that's so fun to listen to. And I'm sorry. That is one of my guilty pleasure songs. Like, that's a song when it comes to the radio has to just be cranked up loud. That and this song and Putting Down the Ritz by Falco. You gotta crank your radio up, bro. I mean, they're just fun ass songs, bro. Like, you know.
It's tied up here too, Harvey. Which way are you going?
I mean, it's pretty obvious, but allow me to retort and say that the Neutron Dance is just as fun a song as your pick. I would just say, you know, doing the Neutron Dance. I will go with the Pointer Sisters happily. Yay.
Well, I'm going to give it to One Night in Bangkok just because I like
fucking guy.
You like fucking lady boys.
Oh, damn. Ladyboys?
There's a reason you're my co-host, Chancy. But
we're not here to yuck anybody's yums.
The reason I'm doing it is I never really listened to either of these songs till this week.
It's fun.
I've heard the Neutron Dance before. I just never knew what it was, and I could swear Neutron Dance was I could swear Homer sang it on The Simpsons at one point, but 30 years ago back on, and I'm not doing that. But it also means Kasey's a tiebreaker, which is the reason I did it.
Literally, Eddie Murphy in the back of a cigarette truck racing through the freaking residential area in Detroit, Michigan, trying to get away from the cops when he's undercover. Fuck Bangkok. It's Neutron Dance. All freaking. I'm just burning doing the Neutron Dance.
And we all know that wasn't Eddie Murphy in the back of that truck. That was clearly a stuntman swinging around.
Oh, duh.
But it was supposed to be Eddie. We know the truth. But I agree entirely, bro.
That means that the Pointer Sisters...
Suspension of disbelief, Harper.
Yes, sir.
That means that the Pointer Sisters will be facing Pat Bantar in round two.
You son of a...
Look what you guys did. Time to face the consequences of your own actions.
Yes.
But, that means Waller starts off the next one.
That was a bitter pill to swallow.
It's Waller starts off the next one, and this one's going to be this one's going to be fucking hard. It's number 55, Sting, If You Love Somebody, Set Them Free, versus number 37, Chicago's You're the Inspiration.
Ooh, this is not hard.
Not at all.
Excuse my language. I don't know, dude. No. Is Sting solo by 85?
Not a sweep.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
It was the first of Sting's solo songs, actually.
Waller, which way you want to go?
I'll go with the Chicago one.
And Chancy?
You know, I think I'm going to also go with Chicago because it's not necessarily Sting's best solo song.
Not at all. It's good. It's not the best, though.
Right.
All right. And that's a breakdown of CJ's. Is it Sting or Chicago?
Chicago all day.
And Harvey?
And Harvey for the win.
And Harvey Boom. For the win. Damn right. I am the inspiration. It's me, damn it. And I'm picking it.
That's You're the song. Meaning in my life.
I am. Well,
you in the 80s, Harvey was the meaning to a lot of ladies' lives. But
I mean, I was 11 in 85, so I don't know what that means. But you know,
Harvey, you know you're one of those boys that matured early, and at 11 you were knocking those boots
very, very early.
I can imagine Harvey picking like a little dandelion and giving it to a girl on the playground.
I've been known to speak to the ladies with the flower in one hand and some Twizzlers in the other.
I can see I know that. How to get that.
Fucking flowers in one hand and fucking bad intentions in the other, maybe.
Shit, bad intentions in both, baby, in both.
That's my VP right there.
But yeah, I'm going with Chicago too because "You're the Inspiration" is one of the first classic rock songs I ever fell in love with. So,
is that a classic rock song? How old am I? Oh my god! Oh,
and it was recorded right before they recorded "Glory of Love" for Karate Kid.
Oh,
hashtag but, you brought up a. Oh, I'm fixing to go off now. CJ opened a can of worms. Ooh, so okay, so I'm gonna reel it back in, and I'm gonna use my upsettedness with the fact that CJ just brought up to pay tribute to the fact that in my birthday draft back in February, somebody on this panel, not naming any names, Harvey Laguerre,
he's called Harvandre on this
stole. Podcast. He's called Jackass Song Stealing Mofo for stealing my Peter Cetera song on my birthday.
But stop using my government name on this podcast, damn it. I'm not trying to have them find me. The whole thing, including Mofo? Come on, man.
It's Chicago. You're the inspiration.
Damn right.
By a landslide.
And that brings it down to Shana. Is it Chicago or Sting?
It's Chicago.
Which means Chicago get the sweep.
Sweep!
But I don't know if it's definitely not going to go that way next round, I don't think. But the next matchup gets started by Chancy. And this is an easy one to me, but I don't know how everybody else is going to feel. It's number 56, Animotion's Obsession. Versus number 36, Duran Duran's The Wild Boys.
Wild Boys is 36?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Mm. I'm going to have to go with Duran Duran.
And CJ, Duran Duran or Animotion?
Oh, you have Duran Duran versus a song that was written by a TV villain. Because for those of you that don't know,
Cesar Romero, the
Animotion song was actually a cover song that was written by Michael DeBaris, who played Murdoch on the original MacGyver.
CJ, I'm thoroughly proud of you right now.
yeah, we got to go with Duran Duran.
There's a reason.
Bro, there's a reason gone. I have this name, okay? Like I said.
Understood.
Deep, bro.
I did not know the depths of your knowledge until now. I bow to you.
But Harvey, are you going to go with Obsession or the Wild Boys?
That's not even the best Duran Duran.
No,
not that it matters. Not that it matters. I will go with Obsession.
And I'm going to agree with you because you're my obsession. I love that fucking song.
Those are great songs.
You want me to be to make you sleep with me.
Where's Vanessa on a podcast when I need her? God damn it. But which way you want to go, Kasey?
Obsession.
That hard of a choice, Kasey?
That's awesome. I mean,
I love both songs. I mean, Duran Duran is iconic 80s music. Obsession is one of those freaking earworm songs that you get stuck in your freaking head and can't freaking get rid of.
I personally don't think you can go wrong with either choice.
And I want to personally say that I hate Wild Boys. I think it's one of the stupidest fucking songs ever made. The only thing it should have ever been was the theme song for the show Wild Boys on MTV.
It was actually a song that Michael wrote by watching a movie about a serial killer.
That's what brings you down to Shana. Is it Wild Boys or is it Obsession?
CJ had me at Villain, so I'm going with Obsession because I kind of feel like this is another one of those songs I could lurk around the neighborhood to.
Yeah. I mean, he literally was watching a movie about a serial killer when he wrote it, and he was in the middle of his heroin addiction. So
sold.
Yeah.
I am happy to tell that this went the way it did, but which way would you have gone, Waller?
Yep.
And that means Obsession moves on 5-2, thank God, but it will face Chicago in the next round. But that means we're at the final.
There are times where I vote against songs on purpose because I know that in the next round, it's going to make it easier for something to get shot the fuck down.
Well, the next matchup.
You're a strategist.
Well, don't worry because Durant's coming back right now. As CJ, this is the only time it's coming back, as CJ starts us off. As number 57, Tina Turner's We Don't Need Another Hero versus number 35, Duran Duran's A View to Kill.
Yeah, this is a Thunderdome song, man. Like, you got to go with Tina on this one, Mike.
We don't need another way.
Yeah.
And when those kids start singing, dude, you know, chills.
Harvey, I'm pretty sure I know which way you're going, but which way are you going?
Yeah. Tina, twice.
Dude, he's singing his freaking choice right now.
Well,
Harvey, my God. Harvey can have my vote.
Well, I mean, it's my vote next, and both of these songs were done better by Northern Kings, but they're both done better by Northern Kings. But I am going to go with A View to... Wait a minute. Mistake if I'm wrong, but was A View to Kill a James Bond song?
Nope. You can... wasn't it? It's not on the soundtrack to A View to Kill? I'm pretty sure it was, wasn't it?
It was isn't a theme Bond? Song. That yeah. movie. It was a theme...
Wasn't it?
Yeah.
It was Bond, wasn't it?
Yeah, because... Well, I'm going to dance into the fire and go with Duran Duran in this one. But which way you want to go, Kasey?
Tina fucking Turner. Yup.
And how about you, Shana? Tina or Duran Duran?
I'm going with the legs. Tina Turner.
I mean, for freaking miles and miles and miles.
I mean, if her legs were that long, she should have wrapped them around Ike's neck and took him the fuck out. But yeah. That's my opinion. But Waller, which way is it going to be? Tina or Duran Duran?
Tina.
And Chancy?
Tina Turner, man.
Even though I know you agree with the Northern Kings comment I made.
I in no way agree with that comment.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, El Prez. Yes.
I'm guaranteeing that besides Chancy, CJ is the only one here who probably ever heard of Northern Kings.
And I don't mean to hurt your feelings, bro. I absolutely love Marco. Phenomenal songwriter, phenomenal bass player. The guy comes from the Bob Dylan school of vocals. Like, not a good singer. Not a good singer. Like, you know. No, Northern Kings are horrible covers.
I'd rather listen to Kids Bop.
I love both of those albums, thank you. They're both amazing cover albums. But
Kids Bop. Yay.
But that means Harvey gets to start in the second play.
Harvey, give me a good one.
You get to start the second play-in matchup of this round, of this bracket. Oh, God.
Okay, what's number 68? I want to hear this one.
It's the first artist in this one. Canada fully apologized for multiple times. It's number 66... Bryan Adams' Run to You versus number 68 Till Tuesday's Voices Carry.
Hush, hush. Keep it down.
Run to you. Yeah, I'm going to go with Till Tuesday.
I'm going to agree with you because I actually like Run to You a lot, but Voices Carry was like the last song in this playlist, and I listened to it a lot because I fucking love that song.
It's some ish.
I always thought they were saying Jerry, though, not Voices Carry. I don't know why, but...
Voices Jerry!
Yeah, see, it sounds like Jerry, but... which way you want to go, Kasey?
I love both songs, but to me, Voices Carry is... Wow. Yeah, Till Tuesday.
All right, and that's gonna bring it down to Shana.
Till Tuesday.
Oh, whatever.
And that means Till Tuesday gets put in the first round. But which way would you have gone, Waller?
Yep.
And Chancy?
Double yup.
And CJ, finish us off.
Yeah, it's Amy Mann all the way, bro. Like. She carried this band, and then she became a phenomenal solo artist. So, yeah, Till Tuesday all day.
All right. And Moose, knock it off. Moose. Dumb mutt. And that means that the next matchup is getting started by me, and it's the final matchup in round one. And it's going to be number 68, Till Tuesday, Voices Carry, versus number 50, Phil Collins and Marilyn Martin's Separate Lives. And
you dirty bastard.
Well, technically, y'all made this matchup, so don't blame me. But I got to go with Voices Carry. But which way do you want to go, Kasey?
Can I blow my load?
Yeah.
We don't do that here.
There was no load blowing here.
Poor CJ's like, what did I just hear?
No, he's been on Bracket Bastards.
Oh. I know what it means. Jesus
Christ.
I mean, if you want to blow your loads, make sure the camera's facing your face. But
I don't think we all want to watch while that happens.
Oh, Jesus, fix it. Phil.
Phil Collins is what he went with, sir.
Okay, I didn't hear shit, so.
I know you didn't. That's why I said it.
And which way you want to go? Which way you want to go, Shana?
I am going with Voices Carry.
They really do, especially when your kids are in the next room. But which way you want to go, Walter?
I'll go with Phil.
And Chanty, it's all tied up. Which way you want to go?
Voices Carry.
And CJ, is it going to be Phil or Voices Carry?
It's Voices Carry, bro. It's Amy Mann.
But that means that round one is officially freaking over. Not the worst time we've had.
Life has new meaning. There's beauty up above and things we never take notice of. You wake up and suddenly you're in love.
Ooh, yeah. That means Kasey gets to start off round two. And round two is going to be, the first matchup is going to be number 64, Phil Collins, Don't Lose My Number, versus number 63, Mary Jane Girls, In My House.
I love Phil. I won't, until something significant comes along, I won't vote against Phil.
Okay.
Bill Collins. Thank you very much. Hey, Shana, you can vote now.
I think.
Good job, Chancy. Good job.
What did I do?
Oh my God.
You took my place while I was gone.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah.
Oh.
At some point, I was going to try and recreate that.
What do you mean at some point? You've been trying this whole time.
So, like, if he steps away, it's, like, the same.
All right, Shannon, which way do you want to go?
I'm going to go with Mary Jane Girls.
Which means we're all tied up at this point. But
Harvey, they voted out Phil Collins in the first round.
Yeah, Harvey. The last matchup in the first round was Phil Collins and Marilyn Martin, Separate Lives versus Voices Carry.
Voices Carry beat Separate Lives?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Not by my choice.
Shit, see what happens when I leave? Damn. Okay.
Well, we assume you would vote for Phil regardless, so it was 4-3. It got beat by, but still.
It happens. It happens. Sorry I had to step away. Small ones having a bit of a fit. I may have to step away again.
Well, keep it going.
It's understandable, man.
Yeah.
Which way do you want to go? Who went last?
What are the songs again?
Who went last, Waller or Shana?
Yes.
Fuck you, Chancy. Oh, Shana went last. Yeah, okay.
See? I was right.
So, Waller, is it Phil Collins, Don't Lose My Number, or Mary Jane Girls in My House?
I don't know, Jerry. Fuck.
I mean, your future fiance is right there, so I mean, you shouldn't say that, but
I'm planning their Applebee's wedding.
Yeah, she is.
Only in Iowa, folks. Only in Iowa, but
I'll go with that.
What'd you
say?
That way
in Washington, too.
Mary Jane.
Which means it goes up to Chancy. Is it Phil
Collins? You offended him so much, he left.
Meh.
Look at what you've done.
He'll get over it.
Look at what you've done. You offended him so much that he fucking left. No, I'm just teasing. I'm sorry. Don't look at me like that. Hey, guys, if I don't mind on a show on Monday, something bad happened. Shanna's probably going to do a show about me at some point.
And, Chancy, I'm sure he'll be black. But what are you going to go with? Are you going to go with Phil Collins or Mary Jane Girls?
I'm going to have to go with Phil Collins on this one.
And that brings it down to CJ. Is it Phil Collins or Mary Jane Girls?
What's the score right now?
All tied up.
3-3 or?
2-2.
Much as I don't really like Phil Collins, we're going to give it to Phil Collins because the other song's kind of annoying. So,
I will give it to Phil Collins though anyway because I would have been next after him, and I would have voted Phil Collins regardless over In My House. But I know, Moose, who would vote for In My House? You're right. But that means Phil Collins will move on to the quarterfinals. And I'm assuming he would vote for Phil Collins anyway. But that means the next matchup to see what Phil Collins is going to face is going to get started off by Shana. And it's number 62, Sade, Smooth Operator, versus number 61, Harold Faltermeyer's Axel F.
I'm going with Sade.
Thank God Harvey left.
He'd have lost his damn mind.
Yeah.
Hopefully he comes
back.
He's typing. Hopefully he comes back. But which way you want to go, Waller?
Is it Sade or the other fucking one?
Axel
left. Oh, Axel left. That would be, yeah, Sade and Axel. Yeah.
Sade gets another one?
No, Sade does.
Sade? All right. And that means that the next vote goes to Chancy.
I am also going to be voting for Sade. I love that fucking Axel Foley stuff, but not in comparison to Sade.
I like when they do it with the hamsters, like when they damn. Yeah.
the crazy frog version is better.
I haven't heard it. I'll have to check it out.
You've never seen Crazy Frog with it?
I probably have, just not registering that's the title of it.
The little blue frog that rides the invisible motorcycle.
No.
They had like they turn it in like to this techno song.
Huh. I know what my evening is. Ow, Larry Quinn.
Well, which way you want to go there, CJ?
Yeah, you got to go with Sade, man. Like, that woman is, she's a force of nature.
So that means Sade moves on to the...
Oh, my God!
Quarterfinals. Sade, whatever. But
I'm getting a stress rash over here.
But that means that Harvey would have gone next, and I honestly don't know who he would have voted for in this one, but it doesn't really matter. I would have given it to Sade too, because Smooth Operator is a damn good song. But Kasey, which way would you have voted?
I swear we're going to get through an entire freaking round with you pronouncing her name correctly at some point.
I'll try.
So, Sade.
All right, which means Sade moves on. But most likely, I would miss. It would have been a sweep, most likely, but we don't know that.
He called me a hoe.
And that means, who calls you a hoe?
He's like, why are you glittery like a stripper? And then he's like, it's right here. And I was like, it's called highlighter. He's like, oh, ho lighter?
Oh, you mean ho lighter?
Hey, Chancy, your girl's trying to get ready for you at midnight tonight, so shut up.
Ooh, maybe a little after midnight. We'll be at a friend's house at midnight.
Yeah, well, nothing like turning 35 and just having a... I mean, not 35. Nothing like turning 38.
I was like, hold up!
I was like, thanks for the compliment, bro, but...
I was thinking 85 and I'm 35, but I mean, nothing like turning 38 and having a full-on orgy, but...
Jesus Christ. Is that what my surprise is?
Fuck no. Jeremy, I swear to fucking God.
Fucking youngins.
There is no God here, but that means
there is in my world, so...
God, after midnight, I'm kicking the Fritos out of my bed and going to sleep.
Right?
Are you sure you don't want to call them first? But Waller, that means the next one starts with you. And it's number 45, Phil Collins, Susudio, versus number 59, Tina Turner's Better Be Good to Me.
Tina.
Yeah. I'm going with Tina. Patrick Bateman stuff aside, fucking, like, that would be fucking
sacrilegious. It's Waller, not you, buddy.
She went with fucking Tina, dude! That means I'm next!
I didn't hear a word she said!
She's still spoken!
What? I thought I said it loud, like normal. Did I whisper it?
I heard you say Tina.
I heard Tina.
Well, excuse me, I'm old and deaf.
Fuck you. I've only got partial fucking percentage hearing in one ear, like 40% on this side and 60% on this side.
Yeah, you're right.
I used to watch a lot of porn with headphones.
So. It's funny because I'll say something to him and he'll be like, "No, dude, you're in my bad ear. What was it?"
My grandparents were married for like over 70 years. And my grandpa used to always say that their marriage greatly improved with the volume on his hearing aid when it became like you could turn it up and down and off. So that was the secret to a good marriage.
And Chancy, which way you want to go?
He said Tina.
Yes, sir. Yes.
I thought he was still silent last time when he started yelling at me. suck the blockage out.
I don't even know what happened.
Yeah, I have no idea.
I sucked the blockage out of my vape. But
it's that's like when you're best slash worst thing at once, all at once.
It's like when your wife's pregnant and her tits get some blockage in there, you gotta suck it out. But
I don't think that's how that works.
Yeah, it is. When they're breastfeeding, if they get blockage, you just suck it out.
Or you could let the baby do it, you weirdo.
Baby's not always doesn't always have strong enough suction. You need a man. But that's the title of Shannon's book she's writing. It need a man, but
no, I'm good.
But that means that it's going to go down to CJ next. Is it Phil Collins, the studio, or Tina Turner's "Better Be Good to Me"?
Yeah. God. Tina Turner. But I want to say the last comment she made. There's a singer named Creed Fisher. He has a song called "Earplugs and Beer" that is pretty much exactly about what you said, like about him buying earplugs and beer and it improving his marriage. So when you said that, I immediately thought of that song.
But you said Tina, CJ?
Yeah, Tina. I'm okay. Not a Phil fan, so thankfully Harvey's not here to hear that. So.
All right, well, that's going to bring it down to me.
That's your way of telling us there's a quarter? Call someone who cares?
What, this? Oh, no, it's just something I do. It's weird. I don't know why. I can just do it.
Are you sweaty?
No.
But, I'm going to give it to Phil Collins because I like Susudio way better than I like "Better Be Good to Me." But which way are you going to go, Shana? Kasey?
Don't freaking skip me.
I didn't. I caught it halfway through.
Tina.
And that means Tina Turner wins 4-1 regardless. But to find out who she's going to face in the quarterfinals.
I don't get to vote.
Oh, no.
Skip to you.
Yeah. All right. Shana, which way would you have gone?
It's going to go 5-1.
Yeah, that's why I didn't think it mattered. But and to find out what she's going to face, which, oh, either way, the quarterfinals is going to be a matchup of the female artist. But the next matchup gets
a 50-50 shot.
Oh, and apparently Amanda's coming onto the show.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, Lord.
Talk about
OnlyFans in a row.
Oh, Lord.
Talk about OnlyFans I want to see. But
thank you. Come again.
Exactly. But that means Chancy's face. But that means that Chancy gets to start out this one to see who's going to face Tina. And it's number 43, Aretha Franklin's Freeway. Aretha Franklin's "Freeway of Love" versus number 65, Cyndi Lauper's "All Through the Night."
Aretha Franklin.
And that means that CJ gets the next vote. Is it Aretha or Cyndi?
Yeah, I have a feeling this one's going to be a futile vote, but I got to go with Cyndi on this one. Sorry.
Well, I'm next, and it's not Futile because I'm going with Sydney because I prefer that song by a fucking mile. But which way you want to go, Kasey?
So Aretha's down 2-1?
Yes, currently.
No, she's not. It's 2-2.
Okay. And Shana?
I'm going with Cindy.
And Waller, is it Aretha or Cindy?
Aretha.
Which means it's a tiebreaker, and I'm hoping that the guest that's coming on is going to pop in any second now to be the tiebreaker.
I'm a quiver with anticipation.
So anyway, how's life for all you people while we sit here and wait?
Oh, you know, we're just doing stuff and things, just hanging out.
So
I'm getting bullied by my dog.
For anybody who cares, tomorrow morning there will be an episode of An Evening at the Movies dedicated to the birthday boy himself.
That was a lot of fun.
So please tune in.
And for anybody else who is interested, tomorrow night we'll be doing. Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead, Kasey.
Well, I was just gonna say, you know, we're discussing Texas Chainsaw Massacre 2. So
Amanda convinced me to watch it last night.
Oh Lord.
Oh yeah, what'd you think, Shana?
I've seen it before. That because I don't remember if you remember or not, but I asked. I was like, which one is the one where they put the meat in the chili?
Oh, yeah, you're right. I do remember now. But that's
like when Dennis Hopper goes into the chainsaw store and just starts grabbing chainsaws and just shaking them around. Like, how is that good? Like, can you maybe not do that? And I need to call the police.
All right.
Instead, he's all like, oh, my aching banana.
Well, Chancy, you can stop your quivering now because we have our seventh member now. And she's the tiebreaker on this final matchup on this side of round two.
Oh no! Okay.
It's number 43, Aretha Frank. It's number 43, Aretha Franklin's "Freeway of Love," versus number 65, Cyndi Lauper's "All Through the Night."
Oh wow!
Welcome to the shit show.
Would it help if you knew which way I voted?
No.
Yes.
No.
I voted for Cyndi. We're Amanda.
Your first
leave us alone.
And Amanda, just to make it better, whoever wins is facing Tina Turner's "Be Good to Me" in the next round.
Okay, I'm gonna go with Aretha.
Thank you. High five.
Sorry, Shan. Oh, real quick, I was watching Renfield. I don't know if anybody's seen it yet, but I'm about 40 minutes in. It's fantastic.
Watching that when I'm done here. Pass.
Which means that Amanda gets to start this round out, which I'm very happy about. And it's Prince in the Revolution at number 51 with Raspberry Beret versus number 52, Billy Ocean Suddenly.
Oh,
I'm telling you, that's why the first round took as long as it did. Every one of these matchups was a
I'm going with Billy Ocean.
Wait till the top. Wait till the
eat
top.
Eat so much, you call it Billy Ocean.
wait till tomorrow with the top 34. Oh, y'all are gonna be hating me.
I'll be high, so I won't care.
Samesies.
I might be.
But that means that it is now CJ's vote.
No, oh, hi, not. CJ.
CJ goes before Amanda.
No, Amanda's an A. She goes in the beginning.
Oh. So you done went and fucked up the damn order then.
Yeah, we're just going to skip Chancy in this one. Then CJ starts out the next one. We're back to normal.
I really hate this matchup because I love both of these songs, and I love both of these artists, and I'm really kind of torn on how to vote on this.
Jeremy, what's behind you?
Chancy.
Chancy.
Okay, that's
like death eating a cracker.
fuck me.
Finally.
It's like death eating a cracker. Okay.
Finally. I've been saying that all night.
See, Harvey, you, what you missed in the last hour and 20 minutes?
I'm sorry.
I'm all for the upset. You know what? Let's go with Billy Ocean on this one, just because, you know.
And I am gonna agree with you, because I know Moose Raspberry Beret is not my favorite song. I know that, buddy. It's gonna be Billy Ocean. But which way you want to go, Kasey?
Suddenly, life has new meaning to me.
There you go.
And that means
always down for a good upset.
That means Billy Ocean beats Prince 4-0 at this point to go to the next round.
Because it was like death eating a cracker.
It is like death eating a cracker. Now it's like death and deja vu.
But Shana, which way you want to go? Would you?
I'm going with Prince. I can't let him go through the round without at least one vote. I love Prince.
That's
and since this is his only representation in the entire bracket, I gotta go with Prince.
Oh, is it really?
Yeah.
It wasn't a big year for Prince, but Waller, which way you want to go?
Prince.
And Chancy, finish us off here.
I thought we were skipping.
It would have been Prince.
Which means Billy Ocean was on 4-3. And don't worry, Waller. You get your 38 birthday punches tomorrow.
Don't feel bad. We'll have Prince represented right here. So
that, very nice. To see who. Shut up, Moose. But to see who Billy Ocean's gonna face, the next matchup gets started off by CJ, and it's number 39, Pat Benatar's "We Belong." Versus number 38, the Pointer Sisters' "Neutron Dance."
Oh.
Well, you know my rules. So that says who I'm voting for. So.
Pat Benatar, yes.
Yeah. You never vote against Pat and Joe. Yeah.
Well, I'm gonna vote against Pat and go for the Pointer Sisters because I love "Neutron Dance."
We know Casey's picking it because it's in Beverly Hills Cop.
I already said that in the first round.
See the shit you miss, but Kasey, which way are you going to go? Because you vote, I'm pretty sure you voted for both in the last round.
I did vote for both in the last round, but again, broken record. Eddie Murphy, cigarette truck, racing through the streets of Detroit, "Neutron Dance."
Not going to fall for the banana.
And that means that it goes down to Shana.
I have to go with Pat.
And which way you want to go, Waller?
Pat.
And how about you, Chancy?
Can anybody see how small my hand is compared to me?
I gotta go with Pat. Sorry, what was you saying, Amanda?
Oh, I just said, oh, dang, about how much bigger your hand is than hers.
Oh, it's...
They're so small.
Aw.
Are you in the kid glove-wearing club, too, Kasey?
Oh, yeah. My hand stopped growing in, like, the fifth grade.
Dude, she got, dude, and everybody thinks, oh, it's so cute. But when not. She fucking balls it up into a fist, those things are like little stones.
The myth about carnies having small hands, it's true. Like, I come from a long line of Carvies, and I have small hands. I don't smell like cabbage, though.
And Chancy likes her small hands because it makes him look bigger. But
exactly.
I don't need her hands.
Wah, wah.
But,
they help
way... They really do.
Just double them up.
I could
probably trip. I was just saying, I probably still have real estate left.
and, And Waller, which way do you want to go? If you, I don't know if you said already.
She said Pat.
Yeah, she said Pat.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
yeah. And that's going to bring it up to Amanda. Is it Pat or Pointer Sisters?
We belong to the life. We belong to the thunder. Sorry.
We belong.
Thank you. We belong together.
Well, I got no complaints so far about the Taylor Swift karaoke the other day, so, you know, it's all good.
And we had a good time.
The amount of watches on that video on Twitter is ridiculous. Just saying.
Really? Nice.
Yeah, my boy Brian, a lot of my friends retweeted it, but my boy Brian Brackett retweeted it and was like, this is one you gotta watch, and since then, it just blew up. But
because we rule.
We do.
But
yeah, I really wanted to watch that night, but as soon as you said Taylor Swift, I was like, sorry, lost me at Taylor Swift.
We might have been able to turn you. That's the thing.
Nope.
And you could have said Prince. You could have said Blue October. You could have said Pink Floyd.
Ooh, Blue October. He's like, somebody get that dog out of here.
It's like fucking Michael Vick's house.
I wear Blue October on my hand.
That's awesome.
But Chancy,
that is my fucking hero. Like, that man is a god.
Chancy, which way would you have gone?
With what?
He said Pat.
Yeah.
Does your dog need to go outside?
I doubt it. He's just being an asshole. Like, oh.
No, Jeremy needs a Q-tip because we've had this problem all night long. Jeremy doesn't hear the votes.
Right. But that means that Pat does move on 5-2. Be like your sister and sit there quietly.
Right.
But
you missed the first time.
The next matchup is going to be a fucking doozy. But let me let this asshole out of his cage before I fucking slap shit of him.
Yeah, just let him out. Give him some cuddles.
Come here, Amanda. Come here, Moe's. Amanda needs a good looking.
Is his name Moe's, like Moe's from The Office?
No, like Moose. His name is Moose.
Oh, Moose. Okay.
Because he's going to be as big as a moose when he's full grown.
Okay.
Oh, God.
Massive. You should see how big his tongue
is. Mercy.
No.
Can you? No. Do you guys need to some time in private or?
Whoa!
No.
He was turning the camera off.
Fucking around, so now she's got to find out. She'll be done in a minute. See,
she's got to tire her out.
It's just like an episode, you know. She comes in for the kill. And she gets like a little bit of an upper hand for a little bit, and then it's like
slap him.
Yeah, she titty slaps me a lot.
You gotta love it when the dogs pull out a fucking taco kit out of a box from expired in 2022.
Yikes!
First off, ew.
Don't let him eat the taco seasoning.
I'm not. I just threw the whole fucking box out, and they pulled it out of a box in the basement. Apparently, they got thrown in there somehow. But that means the next matchup is going to get started by me. And this is a hard one. It's number 37, Chicago, You're the Inspiration. Versus number 56. Versus number 56, An Emotion's Obsession.
No!
Fucking hard.
And I have to give as much as it kills me to Chicago because I love both these songs fully, but Chicago is just more. It's one of those timeless songs I can listen to every fucking day and not get tired of it. Oh, Obsession, yeah. I feel like I would get tired of eventually. But which way you want to go, Kasey?
You're the inspiration.
You bring meaning to my life.
You're the inspiration.
What? Sorry. not Chicago.
And how about you, Shana?
I'm going to go with Obsession again because it's like my creeper theme.
It would be.
And
it's a good song.
And Waller, am I your obsession or am I your inspiration?
Chicago.
Good answer.
Hey,
bypass.
Hey, I'll be her inspiration. I'm good with that. But which way you want to go, Chancy? Is Chicago winning? I mean, I'm sorry, Amanda. Is Chicago winning or is Animotion getting another vote?
I mean, God damn it.
Picture me lurking around shopping malls chasing men while hearing Obsession in my head.
My Obsession. I'm sorry. I have to go with Chicago. It's fucking Chicago. But Obsession had a good run.
Well,
so you can still picture me, can't you?
It really did. It really did because the only song Obsession beat out to get this far is Wild Boys by Duran Duran. So,
oh,
so it didn't really have that good a run. But which way do you want to go, Chancy?
I'm gonna go with Obsession. Oh wait, no, and Chicago. Chicago. I fucked up there.
And CJ, which way would you have gone?
I will go with Chicago. And let me say this for her. I will give you a song to listen to. And you will hear it in a whole new light after I say this. Conway Twitty, Make Believe. Listen to it from the viewpoint of a stalker. And it is the original stalker song, because he's literally singing a song about a woman who he says doesn't know I exist. And he's singing about someone who he's literally creeping on and stalking, who he says doesn't even know I exist.
I can add that to my stalker soundtrack.
And it was written in 1952.
So you're saying that one walked so Every Breath You Take could run.
Yeah, like Make Believe is the original stalker song. Like, it's, most people don't think of the song that way, but when you listen to it and when you have that in your mind, you're going to be like, holy shit, this is like totally a creepy ass song. So,
ooh,
you're welcome.
Ask Harvey what she watched.
Because we want to watch it.
All right, well, yeah. Apparently apparently, our good friend Harvey is out for the night because his daughter's watched a movie they shouldn't have. So his 8-year-old sleeping with him tonight. So we've all been there as parents. Well, most of us have anyway. But
yeah.
But I told him a man took his place. So, you know, white girl to white girl. But
damn.
Chancy's. Oh, I mean, my dog's barking even. Or they saw the girl.
That was a deep one.
Yeah,
that's the girl dog. She's older, but
she's got some bass to her.
Yeah, she does. She's a tenor for sure.
Mastiff for you. But either she has to go out or she's seeing the ghost in the basement. I don't fucking know. But that means that the final match of round two.
That sounds ghosty.
Yeah, the final matchup of round two is going to get started by Kasey, and it's going to be facing Chicago, but it's number 57, Tina Turner's "We Don't Need Another Hero," versus number 68, "Till Tuesday's Voices Carry."
Trouble.
You all made these choices. Don't blame me.
You didn't make these choices. Billboard made these fucking choices.
You know, the only person that's exempt of that statement is Amanda.
Yeah. I wouldn't hear
it. She had no part in making these decisions.
I did not make these rankings.
Kasey, what's it going to be?
Aneurysm right between my fucking eyes.
Wait, man, the top 34 gonna be so much worse.
Tina.
And Shana, how about you?
Tina.
And Waller?
Damn it.
Tina.
Nancy?
Yeah.
God damn you all the hell. And CJ, which way would you have gone?
Yeah, I'm gonna. We can't let Amy Man go out without at least one vote. So yeah, till Tuesday.
Do it for Boston. I was gonna vote for Till Tuesday anyway because it's a better song in my mind. But Amanda, which way would you have gone?
I gotta go with Tina.
Which means Tina wins 5-2 and will face Chicago in the quarterfinals. But that means we are now going into the quarterfinal shortly. Mm-hmm. And that means that the first matchup is going to get started off by Shana. And it's number 64, Phil Collins, Don't Lose My Number, versus number 62, Sade's Smooth Operator.
Sade, oh my you got it God. Right.
There's one. Don't fuck it up now, Jeremy.
Yeah.
Well, get it out of here then.
I'm going with Sade.
Which way are you going to go, Waller?
Yeah, I know.
Oh, I didn't know if you knew how to pronounce it or not.
Yeah, I said it like 20 times.
I don't know, but you looked confused.
I was thinking.
That's her thinking face, you asshole.
Yeah, asshole.
That's not the face he knows, but
it's not her O face, it's her thinking face.
She's like, oh, I what were the that, options? Matt. You're gonna make me say it.
It's Smooth Operator. And then I don't remember what was the second
Collins.
One? Phil Collins, don't lose my number.
Smooth Operator.
And Chancy, are you a smooth operator or you want to lose a number?
I'm fucking smooth operator, man.
You hear that, Kasey? Beat him.
I heard it. I just asked him.
What's up?
I told her to beat you for saying that, but which way you want to go, Amanda?
I have to say, Kasey, so that this is on the record. Second sex tape on my what would my sex tape be called list, Smooth Operator.
Mine would be Poke a Hot Ass.
After Creamy Chaos.
Creamy Chaos.
Poke a Hot Ass.
Hey, that was a good porn.
And I'm that sorry, was a
very
man.
Good porn.
It's not good humping.
I'm sorry, Amanda. I keep forgetting you're on top of Chancy. But CJ, is it Sade or is
nice.
I'm gonna make sure Phil Collins gets one for my man Harvey, even though I don't know, of course you would, dickhole. I like Phil Collins. The Tarzan soundtrack is fire, pure fire. But yeah. Which way would you have gone, Kasey?
You're like fucking 10 years early for that one. Tarzan didn't come out until like 90 fucking 6, bro.
99, yeah, but it was somewhere in the late 90s, but
yeah.
Which way would you have gone, Kasey?
Can't hear you, buddy. I literally wrote it down. I wrote smooth dick operator.
There we go.
Because it hasn't been brought up in an hour and 40 minutes, I will be voting for Kendra Beltran for Smooth Operator.
Kendra doesn't like Sade.
I know.
Oh, okay.
Harvey and I voted for Sade in the first round because Kendra doesn't like Sade.
I love Sade. I just don't like this song, but.
By Your Side is my favorite. Oh, God.
Yeah, all that right, is a well, great song.
That means.
There's been a lot of babies conceived to that song.
Oh, yeah.
That and means they're that, still getting conceived to that song.
But that means Amanda gets to start off the next matchup here. And that's actually fitting because it's a female powerhouse matchup. It's number 59, Tina Turner's Better Be Good to Me versus number 43, Aretha Franklin's Freeway of Love.
Fucking shithole.
I gotta go with Aretha on this one. That song's a banger.
Banger!
Are we riding on the freeway?
Yeah.
I mean, I'd rather ride on a gangbang of love, but which way you want to go, Chancy?
Significantly less fun for the female.
Yeah.
Throw well, that out there.
I'm not a female, so it's fun for me.
What are the options again?
I'm here for the gangbang.
Like, I got distracted.
Yeah, I got, that made me think of that fucking I'm here for the gangbang scene.
Thank you. I'm glad somebody got that.
In the words of Dr. John Volby, let's all go to the gangbang. Let's all go to the gangbang.
And Chanty, it's Freeway of Love versus Better Be Good to Me. Tina versus Aretha.
Oh, shit. Tina.
Ha ha.
And which way do you want to go, CJ?
Yeah, damn it.
Right?
Do it.
You know what? I'm going to go with Chancy on this one. I got to go with Tina.
Well, I'm going to cancel out your vote and go with Aretha because that song is way better than Better Be Good to Me. But which way do you want to go, Kasey?
Aretha!
Am I supposed to recognize those lyrics? Oh, okay, yeah. Yeah, I don't know if you realize, Kasey, but you cut out a lot when you talk. But I think it's your Wi-Fi.
Fucking Wi-Fi.
Yeah, this is Wi-Fi.
But which way you want to go, Shana? Are you going to tie it up? Are you going to go for Tina and tie it up, or are you going to make Aretha win?
I am going with Tina.
Which means it's a tie for Waller. Is it Tina or Aretha? Better Be Good to Me or Freeway of Love.
She hates it when this happens. Her whole life just flashes before her eyes.
God damn it. I'll go with Tina.
Damn you!
Scuba Steve, damn you!
That'll be your guys' first dance at the Applebee's wedding.
Yeah.
Which, damn you dirty apes, look what you've done. But that means that we're going to go to the other side of the quarterfinals now. And this one gets started off by Chance a lot. And it's number 52, Billy Ocean Suddenly, versus number 39's Pat Benatar, We Belong.
Oh, Jesus, fix it.
Pat Benatar.
And CJ?
Amanda?
He's going to come back and be like, what was your vote?
What?
No, it's CJ's
your vote.
Oh.
Amanda goes last. CJ's vote.
No. Oh. CJ already voted. You just didn't see it.
Oh, well, you got to realize the bracket's on a separate screen than the actual fucking video. So,
no, I mean, you were like away from, you know, AFK.
I shouldn't have to say that. I already told you I'd never vote against Pat. So.
I have my co-host when I'm away, Chancy.
Oh, yeah. That guy. Fuck that guy.
I haven't seen that for a
while. I heard he's an asshole.
Yeah, right? Total fucking douchebag.
I heard he smells like rancid peanut butter.
I mean,
I heard
he likes the fact that his girlfriend's hands are smaller because it makes it easier for her to play with his butt. But.
I don't even know what that means.
Hey, he's okay.
I don't want to know what that means.
He's like okay. Death eating a cracker.
He's okay. He ordered the Psycho Funkopus record, so, you know.
Oh, I ordered both of them, dude.
That's what I'm saying. That's you're all fucking K in my book just for that alone. Like,
but
you know, I'm like if you went out and robbed a bank tomorrow, you'd still be okay in my book just based on that.
Standards are low, but I'm gonna give my vote to Billy Ocean because I think it's a way better song than Pat Benatar. But which way you want to go, Kasey?
You can't go wrong with either one of the two of them. So,
you gonna go for the black vote or the female vote?
I'm gonna go with the Texas OU chili cook-off and go Pat Benatar.
Kasey, if you ever call it Texas OU again, I will disown you.
No, you won't.
Yes, I will. Texas OU. OU Texas. Get that shit right.
Texas OU chili cook-off.
Listen here, you boomer sooner.
And Chancy, I mean, not Chancy, Waller, are you going to tie it up for, I mean, fuck me, Shana, are you going to tie it up for Waller or are you gonna, by going no, with...
Shana, Jeremy made a request.
Yeah.
What was the request?
I used to make a lot of requests to Shana's, but she hasn't listened. But is it Billy Ocean suddenly or Pat Benatar we belong, Shana?
It is not Billy Ocean. It's Pat Benatar.
Which means, unfortunately, Pat Benatar moves on to the quarterfinals.
Not unfortunately.
I think, unfortunately. I would have had Billy Ocean.
She is the reason that in the fourth grade, I had a she mullet.
God help you.
Yeah.
Nice.
Like, I don't know if anybody can imagine the grace that was me in the fourth grade. Picture this.
I can picture the haircut on you.
1987, fourth grade Shana has a she mullet for picture day, followed by horn-rimmed glasses with strawberries on the side. It gets better. I was wearing my Brownies uniform with my sash.
To school?
Yes, for school pictures. Like, because this was cool.
Nerd alert.
If this was not enough, I was also missing my two front teeth.
Pictures are didn't happen.
We need to see pictures of this.
I will try and get my hands on some. But yeah, it was something.
You know what's interesting? I also had a she mullet, and I also, in that picture, had my two front teeth missing. It's because we're the same age.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, Oklahoma, Iowa, I mean, yeah, similar states. So, but, I mean, Shana, were you the poster child for the video, How Not to Get Abducted Children?
I was actually almost abducted. Like, legit story.
Interesting. And you should
I got
go
flashed
along.
Once.
See, I would have been way better with that.
I've done that to girls, but yeah.
God damn it, Jeremy. All right, move on.
Well, like not children, though.
No, not children. But I mean, if you're.
That's
if
what
your friends,
she's talking about.
Yeah. I don't. I was tired. No. Well, okay. Was it another child or was it an adult?
It was an adult. It was an adult man flashing me while I was walking home from school.
Oh, Jesus fucking Christ. This is such a hard left turn.
Jeremy's like, I've done that before.
Nobody's going to clip that.
I've been driving through the mall parking lot.
Reel it back in here, people.
All right.
Jeremy's not allowed to own a trench coat.
I've been in the passenger seat. I've been in the passenger seat of my friend's car driving through the mall parking lot, and you see some girls you think are cute, and you whip it out to be like, hey, want to come play?
Oh, Jesus.
That is not what...
You don't want to see that, no. Right? God.
Like, I've told Amanda this, like, when we've talked about this before. A man's penis is like a mouse with a cat. Like, we can see that you're proud of it, but we don't want to see it.
Yeah, like, we just want to feel it.
Yeah, well, I'm going to look at that. I'm going to just, like...
Hey, Chancy, you hear the shit? Yeah, man, it's fucked up shit.
I'm fairly certain never in the span of his life has Chancy been in a car with a bunch of dudes that just decided to whip it out at girls in the mall parking lot.
Yeah, you
don't think
know.
That's common practice.
You don't know who the fuck he hung out with, because I can see it.
Okay, so while
your friends,
while she has a point, that never happened. That specific scenario never happened.
Yeah. Okay. Not in a mall parking lot. It was McDonald's. Get it right, fuckers.
No. Nowhere was I ever in a vehicle full of dudes just randomly driving around trying to find someone to fucking pull our dicks out at.
And Vito's watching the show right now. Like, Chancy whips out me all the time. So I don't know what he's talking about.
I need everybody to hold the phone for a second, and maybe you already know this. Netflix is releasing a Wham! Documentary on July 5th.
Oh, that's funny. Nice. That's funny. Wham's in tomorrow's bracket.
Wake me up
before you go, because I don't plan and go solo.
But, well,
Amanda and I will be going on tour this summer.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
But that means that this next vote goes to, I have no fucking clue at this point. But
we are so far off the fucking rails, it's ridiculous.
Shannon, we call it the Creamy Chaos Tour.
and actually, no. Shannon, you voted last, right? If I'm not mistaken?
I don't know. Probably.
See, this is actually fitting for my birthday bracket, that it just goes completely off the fucking rails.
Yeah, man, this is your show, not mine. Like, I'm the motherfucker who's infamous for going off the rails.
Well,
who invited me?
All right. Well, I believe it's Waller's vote. Is it Billy Ocean or Pat Benatar?
Right.
Pat.
And that's going to bring it down to Amanda last. Is it Pat Benatar or Billy Ocean?
I thought I already voted. It's Pat Benatar.
Yeah.
Oh, then
probably didn't.
She voted in her mind.
All right, well, Pat Benatar wins 5-1 because I'm the only one who wanted to give Billy Ocean a vote. But that to see what Pat Benatar is going to face, this one is going to get started off by CJ. And it's number 37, Chicago, You're the Inspiration,
yep.
versus number 57, Tina Turner, We Don't Need Another Hero.
Oh, fuck me.
Chi-Town. Gotta go with Chi-Town.
What are you, the Doobie Brothers? But
hey, I picked the Doobies over both of these, but I mean,
but just to put it out there, Tina could end up against Tina in the final. If things go a certain way, Tina will end up against Tina in the finals.
I don't see that happening.
But I gotta give mine Chicago as well. I'm giving mine Chicago as well because I like that way better than You're the Inspiration is so much better to me than We Don't Need Another Hero, even though Northern Kings did that song better. But which way are you gonna go?
We're 75% of the way. We're 75% of the way to We Don't Need Another Hero being out of this damn tournament. Shannon,
Chancy,
you
which way are you going?
Chicago.
All right. Yeah, obviously. Shanna?
I'm going with Tina.
Boo, you whore.
I am, I know. We typically can smell our own, Amanda.
True.
And Waller?
Tina or who?
Chicago.
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 I will go with... I'll go with Tina.
And Chancy, are you going to tie it up and go for Tina, or are you going to make Chicago win?
It doesn't Amanda go
with Chicago? I'm sorry, Amanda. I can't forget she's on top of you, man. What can I say?
Yeah, Amanda, you know.
Amanda, is it going to be Chicago or Tina?
That's definitely Chicago.
Which means Chicago wins. And Chancy's probably as happy as a tiebreaker on this one. But which way are you going, Chancy?
I mean, it would have been a hard choice for me, but I probably would have went with, I don't know, man. Probably Tina.
You're the inspiration.
Then I am extremely happy you didn't have that choice, but.
Yeah.
That means that the quarterfinals are over.
And I want you here with me.
And that means we're going to go into the semifinals now. And that means that the first vote on this one goes to, oh, look, me. Uh-huh. And it's number 62, Smooth Operator, versus number 59, Tina Turner's Better Be Good to Me. And I am 100% going for Smooth Operator because I don't like Be Good to Me. It's not a good song in my mind. But... And I didn't listen to it, so I'm voting against it. But which way you want to go, Kasey?
Kendra. Sade.
And how about you, Shana?
Sade.
And Waller?
Sade.
Which means Smooth Operator moves into the finals. But which way would you have gone, Amanda?
Yep.
And Chancy?
Yup.
And CJ?
Yup.
Which means Smooth Operator beats Tina Turner into the finals with a sweep. Holy fuck, I didn't see that coming at all. But
that means you aching? Yup, for some bacon. Yup.
And I'm salty that one night in Bangkok didn't make it past the first round.
Me too.
I tried.
What beat it?
I'll look that up real quick. Don't
lose my
Neutron Dance beat it.
Okay.
Which I honestly couldn't be mad either way with that one, but still, I wanted One Night in Bangkok to make it further. I don't think I ever heard that song this week.
But you haven't seen The Hangover 2 where Mike Tyson sings right? it?
I never even seen most of the first Hangover.
Wasn't it? Come to think of it.
Yeah, at the end.
Mike Tyson singing One Night in Bangkok is gold.
But that means that the other side of the semifinals gets started off by Shana. And it's number 39, Pat Benatar, We Belong.
Dude.
What?
By who?
I'm sorry, Kasey. Yes, Kasey.
Call your tits, dude.
Well, he was playing with them earlier, so. But
I was not.
I saw you with your hands. Here like you had your hands, your shirt going like this.
No, whatever.
But that means Kasey starts off this one. And it's number 39, Pat Benatar, We Belong, versus number 37, Chicago, You're the Inspiration.
Never mind, Shana, you can start. Chicago.
And Shana, which way do you want to go?
Pat Benatar.
And how about you, Waller?
I'll go with Pat.
And Chancy?
Yep.
And Amanda?
It's like Sophie's choice. I'm gonna go with Chicago.
CJ?
We already know. He said. You're not voting against Pat.
But it's Chicago. Yeah. That might be the exception to his book.
Yeah, it's really not kind of. It's still Pat. Yeah.
Oh, you dick. I was
hoping. Patty and Joan! Damn it!
You are the inspiration. Come on.
I was hoping you would have given me a tiebreaker because it would have definitely been Chicago if I got the tiebreaker. But. That means Pat Benatar moves into the final. When you say we belong to the light, we belong to the thunder. We belong to the sound of the words we both fall in under. Whatever we deny or embrace, for worse or we get to the finals, we have a third and fourth place match to do. And that one is going to get started off by Shana. Yeah, this time. And Shana, it's going to be...
May?
It's going to be May.
No, we're not in that. We're not
them anywhere.
We're not in this decade. We're not in that decade yet. But it's going to be Tina Turner, Better Be Good to Me, number 59, versus number 37, Chicago, You're the Inspiration.
Oh, sure. Now.
I'm going Tina.
What?
And that's going to bring you down to Waller.
Amanda, you know how I feel about toxic men. So if some dude saying you're the inspiration to me, I'd be like, yeah, I gotta go home.
Like, you need to learn how to allow love into your life,
woman. Yeah. Big Don Vito's waiting for you.
I'm good.
You two have the perfect perfect mindsets for each other, though.
One of us would end up in a trunk of a car.
I want to see one of you put the other in the trunk of a car, like, literally.
What'd you say?
Shana has me on speed dial.
Trying to lift Don Vito be like fucking trying to lift the car itself. Just saying, but
I'll go with Chicago.
I love you, Don Vito, but we're big men. We can make fun of a girl like that. But oh, he stopped watching. Oh, poor Vito. But which way do you want to go, Chancy? Chicago or Tina?
Oh, I'll go with Tina. Keep it spicy.
Traitorous bastard.
And which way do you want to go there, CJ?
Chicago.
And I'm going to go Chicago, too, because it's way fucking better than Better Be Good to Me. But people are looking at the artists I hear, and I think, and not the actual songs. But which way do you want to go, Kasey?
Chicago.
Actually, well, it doesn't matter. But Amanda, which way would you have gone?
Chicago.
Yeah, that's why I said it didn't matter. That would have been your vote regardless. But that means Chicago gets third. Your inspiration gets third place, and Tina Turner's Better Be Good to Me gets fourth place.
I feel like that's not right.
It's right. But the finals are going to get started off by Chancy, since it's his birthday bracket. And it's number 62, Sade's Smooth Operator, versus number 39, Pat Benatar's We Belong.
Shit. Damn. I'm gonna go with Sade, man.
And Amanda?
Pat Benatar. We Belong is a fucking anthem. Smooth Operator is just okay.
And CJ?
Yeah. Pat.
I'm honestly surprised Smooth Operator made it this far, but I'm still voting for it because I like it better than We Belong. But
what?
Okay. I'm a guy. But which way do you want to go, Kasey?
I don't think it's going to matter, but
it's tied up at this point.
Yeah, but I know I have a feeling in my gut I know where Shanna's going to vote after I vote. So
well, it's her stalker song, so you don't know.
We'll go with Sade.
And Shana, is it Smooth Operator or We Belong?
I really, really enjoyed the Bard and Bella's rendition of We Belong as well.
Me too.
So I'm going to go with We Belong.
Which means it's a tiebreaker for Waller. Is it We Belong or Smooth Operator? She just said she's about to have a heart attack. Because it's the final.
You're not Fat Amy no more, though.
I have really bad anxiety. I hate this shit.
Fuck! Big spider.
Good. Hope it bites you. What were the options?
Sade.
Mm-hmm. Die, you creature! Die, squish.
Just a spider. Put your big boy panties on.
I don't like spiders, dude.
I choose Sade.
No!
Yeah!
The box is down! No!
That's redonkulous.
That means that Sade's smooth operation.
And we're back.
Oh my god!
You did so good in the beginning. Oh, wow.
So well.
Might as well just call her Sadie.
That means that Sade's smooth operator will face whoever wins tomorrow's top 34 bracket of 1985 songs for the ultimate grand championship. And that means that the final four in this were Tina Turner better be good to be in fourth place. Chicago, You're the Inspiration at third place. Pat Benatar, We Belong at second place. And Sade, Smooth Operator at first place. And the funny thing is, the song ranked 62 out of 68 on these brackets won first place in this half. And it beat all songs that were ranked higher than it.
I feel like this is completely not correct.
It's Billboard. Blame Billboard, not me.
No, I mean how this bracket went. I don't feel like Smooth Operator was the...
It was.
I wasn't here for the first round, so I don't know.
Smooth Operator. I was the one to use Smooth Operator, which I know. Oh, it beat Whitney Houston, You Give Good Love.
Are you fucking kidding me?
It beat it with a sweep, by the way. And it beat Phil It beat Phil Collins, Don't Lose My Number.
Well, yeah, okay.
By 6-1.
I voted for that.
And then it beat Tina Turner, Very Good to Me. So it
You Give Good Love is amazing. What is wrong with you people?
I'm sorry. And it beat out Axel F in the second. It beat out Axel F in the second round.
Oh yeah. So, all right.
Hey, that was one that Harvey got on his soapbox for was Sade and Whitney.
Yep. Yeah, I don't care. I'm just kidding.
But. Shit like this is exactly why every one of my brackets are randomly generated, because
it's I've done randomly generated brackets, and they're still ask Kasey when he did the conspiracies bracket earlier this week. The randomly generated ones are fucked up as hell sometimes.
They can be fun though.
Yep,
like that Prince one was pretty crazy with some of the matchups. Like,
oh, it was. I mean, you need to get Amanda Harvey and DeAndre and Kasey on that.
Need to make a bigger one if we're going to have all them people, though, because then you can have more fun with
it. Yeah, there was 64 one. That's fine. But,
on the what?
Prince.
What am I getting volunteered for?
Prince?
Oh, yes.
I want to play.
Oh, well, I mean, if he wants to make like a 10 person bracket, then that's going to be lasting like 5 hours, but you know.
Thanks.
But
yeah,
that brings us to a close for tonight, folks. And be sure to come back tomorrow and check out the top 34 songs from 1985. Which, honestly, personally, I kind of like the second part playlist better than the first. But I think that's because the first is more pop, but and less rock. But we'll see tomorrow. But and I will do this for the person who had to leave early. You can find Mr. Harvandre Laguerre at Men of the Prize podcast or Love is Black podcast, and you can find him as I Did Not Make These Rankings Network. Or you can also find him, I think it's on WGBN-TV. I believe that's correct channel. I'm not sure. But, or you can find him wherever there's hot, sexy black men. But Amanda, where can they find you?
Hi, Andre. I am the host of The Sip List. You can find that at thesiplistpod.com, as well as at the I Did Not Make These Rankings website. And I also co-host shows with Kasey and Shana, which I'm sure they'll tell you about.
And speaking of them, Kasey, where can they find you?
I am the host of An Evening at the Movies with the emergency replacer, Amanda. We can be found pretty much everywhere you get your podcast listening fix. We've got new episodes coming each and every Wednesday. I also co-host a podcast with Amanda and one that I will let Shana explain to you since I'm that kind of guy. So Shana, as you were.
You're the kind of guy that makes women explain everything? Okay.
Yep.
Before we get to her,
we trained our whole lives for that.
Before we get to that point, CJ, where can they find you?
I am everywhere. Any social media, you can pretty much find me as Music God CJ playing all one word. And the website is riotonthesetmedia.rocks. And if you go to YouTube, you can look up Music God Reacts. That's the music reaction channel. It also hosts both of the podcasts, the Noize Report, which is the main one, and the Racket Brackets, which is getting ready to kick off again. I got a bunch of episodes of recording this weekend, and let me finish by saying I want to do What's Eating Gilbert Grape on an evening at the movies, Harvey. So,
Kasey,
God damn it! So when you're free to do that, please.
Yes. I love that movie.
It's a great movie.
Love that movie. That one and Marvel Warriors are like my favorite two movies of all time.
I just watched What's Eating Gilbert Grape this week for a Bracket Bastards episode coming up.
Fucking phenomenal. Most heartbreaking ending of any movie ever. Like just
Mama.
That ending is
it's even a better ending when they did it with squirrels on American Dad. But yeah.
That's not.
It was a better
ending. Why you gotta fuck shit up, bro? Like
Look it up on YouTube. It's a great scene. But Shana, where can they find you besides creeping out the bars?
And department stores and neighborhoods and
Pascal's backyard.
Hide your children, hide your wife.
Outside your bedroom window.
Amanda's got it right outside Pedro Pascal's window because I'm a super creep. Super creep. So you can find me and Amanda on Tuesday mornings. We will be returning very soon for Crime Rewind. Woo! Doing a little bit of a mental health break for right now. Mental health is important. And then you can also find Amanda, Kasey, and I on Literature Reapers, where we read some books and then talk about them.
As soon as Amanda buys the next book that we're supposed to be reading.
Yeah, I got 2 weeks.
Well, since you disappeared, where can they find Waller, Chancy, besides underneath you in about 15 minutes?
They can't.
That about wraps it up.
Sums it up.
Oh, you could find Waller outside Chancy's window whenever
he's anybody in Rumsford home. On this podcast can get a hold of me if need.
That's right. And Chanty, where can they find you besides screaming in about 15 minutes, happy birthday to me?
It's actually an hour and 15 minutes for us.
I don't know when he came out of the hole, actually, so I'm not counting that.
Valid. Well, you're on Eastern time.
Yeah,
I'm
Central time.
I still got a buck 15 to go, bud. But, you know.
Fuck time zones, but yeah.
You're right. You know.
Right.
So, you know, Facebook, my name, good luck spelling it. Fucking TikTok and Instagram is Red Eye Roundtable. And Twitter is just Red Eye Table. And you can find me on Maniacal Music Musings on the YouTube channel so you can see this mug. And on Spotify so you can hear this sultry voice or something.
And you can find him on an evening at the movies tomorrow morning.
Fuck yeah, you can.
Like death eating a cracker.
Like death eating a cracker.
I cannot wait to listen to the beginning of that. I was so fucking high, I could not stop laughing.
It's an hour and a half of nothing but Amanda giggling.
But yes, you can find both of us on Facebook as Paranormal New Normal / Maniacal Music Musings Podcast with S Facebook group. Name change coming soon. And you can find us on Twitter and the gram as at Juggalo Bastard. You can find us on TikTok as at Juggalo Bastard Podcast. And as my iSocket loving co-host said, you can find us on YouTube as Maniacal Music Musings. Or you can find us on Mantispace. Or you can find us on the Blind Knowledge Network where we stream live on YouTube whenever we do a show. Because all knowledge is blind until Chancy found it. But you can catch us tomorrow night, same time, same crazy fucking place, for the top the top 34 1985 songs. And Chancy still doesn't know everybody that's on tomorrow's show, so that's going to be even more fun. Might be some exes, might be, who knows, but we'll see. Until then, we'll catch you next time. Musers are going to be musing. No need to ask, he's a smooth operator.